From Fitton Field on the campus of the College of Holy Cross in Worcester, Massachusetts, Charter TV3 presents live coverage of New England college football. This afternoon, two longtime Northeast rivals square off as the Colgate Raiders visit the Holy Cross Crusaders. It's college football on Charter TV3. Hello, everyone. Welcome inside the broadcast booth. Kevin Shea alongside of Andy Lacombe. And big game today for both teams. Holy Cross looking to go 3-0 in league play, and Colgate looking to win their first league game of the season. Both teams came into the season with Patriot League championship hopes. At the end of the game today, one will take a giant step forward and one could be eliminated.
Could be on the way back. You just never know. Every game is so important right now for both of these teams. For Holy Cross, it's this week and four more. It's all in front of them for their ultimate goal, which is to win a Patriot League championship. It is their path. It's both teams' path to the postseason. Colgate made a run deep into the postseason last year. They are still a favorite in this conference because of the talent they have on that roster.
It's two of the programs with the richest tradition in football in the Patriot League, Colgate and Holy Cross. We're back with the opening kickoff right after this.
Our founders would have never seen this coming.
Spygate?
No.
Deflategate?
No.
What then?
Benji!
Benji knocks down any obstacle that he can get his paws on and tackles every high interest rate that gets in between us and our customers, which is why he made the Bay State Savings Bank team.
You're right. They would have never seen Benji coming, but I'm sure they're glad he came.
Bay State Savings Bank. We take banking personally.
I'm District Attorney Joe Early Jr., and I'm proud to partner with Charter Communications with our pledge to help raise awareness that bullying should not be tolerated. From local school students, here's our message.
Make the grade. Join the anti-bully crusade. Who wants a bully for a friend?
We need to foster safe environments for students in their schools and communities. Join the anti-bully crusade. Take a stand to lend a hand. Don't be a bully.
Presented by the Law Offices of Joseph J. Coriglio.
In my hand here?
Bacon, lettuce, and tomato sandwich.
Oh, I'd love that right now. It is a copy of the Old Farmer's Almanac. November 2019, that's when it starts. The snowiest periods will be mid-November, mid to late December, and early and late January.
That was me blowing hot air.
You're listening to the Jim Polito Show, your safe space.
Welcome back, everyone, to Fitton Field. Kevin Shea alongside of Andy Lacombe. Brenna Wilson is with us down at field level as we get ready to kick it off. Holy Cross and Colgate, big Patriot League game. Holy Cross coming in 3-4, 1-0 in league play, or 2-0 in league play. And now we send it down to Brenna Wilson, who recently caught up with the head coach, Bob Chesney.
Coach, records aside, this is a big game as you get into the Patriot League. What do you guys have to do today?
We got to hold on to the football. I think when we went back and looked at it, just how many three and outs we had last week. We have to sustain drives. We can't get knocked off schedule. First down's got to be big for us. Be efficient. Second down, get us into a third and manageable, and then keep those drives alive. We didn't do that very well last week. That's something we got to do right now.
Thank you, Coach.
All right. Thank you, Brenna. Thank you, Coach. Bob Chesney in his second season as the head coach of the Holy Cross Crusaders. He has had tremendous success wherever he has gone. He has had a winning league record in each one of his stops. Last year was the first time he didn't have a winning overall record in his coaching career. And Dan Hunt, you look at what he's done. This is his sixth year with Colgate. First 5 years, three Patriot League Coach of the Year awards. Mm-hmm. Last year they were a top 10 team, led the nation in scoring defense. Just a phenomenal run for this guy in a short period of time at Colgate.
Yeah, and they were in unfamiliar territory. You look at the series, this is the 82nd meeting, and Holy Cross leading in that series. But Colgate's won 7 in a row, and they've won 17 out of the last 22 in this series. But for Colgate, they won last week against Cornell. It was their first win in 322, almost an entire year, 322 games. They lost their last loss, or their last win was in the playoffs and they lost in those playoffs to eventual national champ North Dakota State. So, you know, this is a power program, but they are in unfamiliar territory, being 1-7 coming in this week, and, you know, maybe just starting to get it going now. Quarterback's healthy, still have a lot of preseason All-Patriot League team guys. The quarterback, Brenneman, is the Patriot League preseason offensive player of the year. Is he starting to get it going, coming off his best game and a win over Cornell last week? These are the concerns for the Holy Cross side, that, you know, there's still a ton of talent on the Colgate side. They played a brutal non-league schedule, just like Holy Cross did, playing Air Force and Villanova, some of those teams. So, you know, 1-7, you can't really look at that record. And Holy Cross and Bob Chesney, that's what he talked about this week. We're only talking about Colgate. We're talking about how good they are and what we need to do to stop them this week.
Colgate coming in with 10 preseason all-league selections. That was the most in the Patriot League. So this is a team, as you mentioned, without question, has a ton of talent. Tough preseason schedule, but again, so did Holy Cross play a tough preseason schedule. And Bob Chesney said, talking about that pre or the non-league schedule that Holy Cross played, it wasn't about the results. Obviously, he would have liked to win more, but he was really happy with how they played each team, that they played for the full 60 minutes. And he said, particularly on defense, we fought. We are fighters on defense, and he really likes what he saw from his defense. Opening up at Navy and what they did against Syracuse. Syracuse, they held him inside the 10 once. Syracuse running, trying to run between the tackles a couple times in a row. And that Holy Cross front seven bowed up, and particularly the front four, that defensive line. And they stopped Syracuse on a couple stops and turned it over.
Yeah, no question about it. Late in those games, they were fighting, they were competing. And they think it's going to pay off dividends here in the Patriot League schedule. No question about it. Holy Cross deferred. They're going to put that defense on the field first. And we're set to go from Fitton.
One of the best kick returners in the league is back for Colgate, but they kick away from him. And now let's see the Holy Cross special teams. Bouncing to the outside is Gruber. And he's run out of bounds at the 24-yard line.
Yeah, pretty good return from Gruber. The Holy Cross lost the contain on the edge just a little bit, but Terrell Prince is just so quick. He's able to cut down that distance quickly and get the ball carrier out of bounds. Here's Grant Brenneman in that offense. You know, he's healthy now, missed a couple of games in the middle of the season. Three touchdown passes, three interceptions. But this is a guy that, you know, can be the best quarterback in the conference.
And Colgate has two very talented running backs. They'll throw it on first down. Chris Riley getting in there and laying a stick on the intended receiver, Nick Drop.
And Corey Stefanik may have gotten a hand on the football just beyond the line of scrimmage. Stefanik and Riley on that defensive side, they're so active. They're all over the football field. And they're the leaders. They're the older guys. They're the veterans here, along with Mark Ebo.
1 running back in the backfield with Brenneman. Brenneman to throw on first or second down with time, and it's blocked at the line of scrimmage. Whitley got it. Whitley has been a beast all season long for Holy Cross on the defensive line, and Benton Whitley got a big pop there and knocks it down.
Yeah, you know, they're big and they're tall, that defensive line. Here's the offensive line for Colgate. Sam Deal in the middle of it with Jovan Wolford, the senior big guy, in the left tackle spot. Twyman's the leading rusher right now. Nick Diaco, a talented senior and a tight end who plays a lot of different positions, it seems, on the field, has run the football a little bit as well.
They've put Diaco in the Wildcat formation back there. It's third down and 10 for the Raiders. Brenneman under pressure, dumps it out to the flat, incomplete. It was intended for Diaco, the big tight end, but Holy Cross got good pressure on Brenneman and forced him to get rid of it in a hurry.
Yeah, they brought some defensive backs through the left side there of the Holy Cross defense, and Brenneman still nearly was able to complete that pass. Good awareness downfield, but a good start for this Holy Cross Crusader defense, a 3-and-out.
Barney Armour will punt it away for Colgate. John Roberts standing at the Holy Cross 30. Holy Cross should get good field position. It's a low kick, short kick, lands at the 41. Holy Cross has to get away from it. It takes a Colgate roll, and quite a roll. That hit at the 41 of Holy Cross. It's downed at the 26, and that's where we will get our first look at this Crusader offense.
Yeah, and you know what? Corey Stefanik wasn't far off from getting to that punt. So the Crusaders may see something there
down the line on special teams. Here's Connor Dagenhart, the junior signal caller. Has been a pretty good game manager in terms of his numbers. He did turn the ball over a couple of times last week with an interception and a couple of fumbles. But overall, has taken care of the football this season.
Dom Cozier, second team all-league selection a year ago, gets the call on first down. Cozier picks up 1.5. One of the keys, Bob Chesney said, for this game is how we run the football. We have to establish the run. The deepest group we have on offense is our running backs. We need to play power football. And he told his offensive line this week, I am putting it on you. It's on your backs this week.
That's a good challenge for Chris Smith's bunch up front. They are highly touted.
Second down and 9. Dagenhart hands it off. Cozier, first down and more. Burst into the secondary, across midfield, into Colgate territory. Foot race down the sideline. He's bumped out of bounds inside the 20-yard line. Dom Cozier got a great seam, and he exploded.
Well, he had a 66-yard touchdown early on, but I look at Jack Bowler, who puts a big block from his guard position and really sprung Cozier through the left side behind Boddy and Foley. 68, Bowler there right in the middle making a play.
Cozier ran for over 100 yards against Brown last week. Almost got it against Harvard, gets to the outside, turns the corner, flag comes in late.
Yeah.
Cozier bumped out at the 10. It would be a first down for Holy Cross.
They're going to get a Yerasante for a block in the back from the receiver position.
And Bob Chesney yelling at Asante now from the sideline.
Number 15. 10-yard penalty.
Asante, one of their good, young, freshman receivers. A high-speed guy, but he just does get a little bit in the back there and maybe didn't even have to make that contact, and that's what his head coach was telling him after the fact with Cozier's speed to the outside.
Bob Chesney said, we really need a big game from our receivers. Spencer Gilliam, Ayurasante, Tenny Oeni, those three have to have big games for us. Peter Oliver's in the backfield now. Oliver gets the carry. Oliver gets out to the 20-yard line, just shy of the 20-yard line.
Well, offensively for Holy Cross, it's Foley, Boddy, and company up front. You already saw Jack Bowler making a play, and Big Jackson Dennis as well. Dom Cozier, Derek Mountain, the tight end, Ayani Gilliam, among the guys you will see in that receiving core. And you're right, Kev, he really put it on guys like Tenio Ayani, one of their leaders. Our receivers have to make plays this week, according to Bob Chesney. And
Connor Dagenhart looks to the sideline. Second and 10 for Holy Cross. Dagenhart looking left, firing to the end zone, has a man, incomplete. He was looking for Ayerasante, the freshman, and it was broken up.
Yeah, it's a pretty good ball here and just very good coverage from Colgate. They got back there and made a play. I think it was Colin Hurd who got back there, but a pretty good ball from Dagenhart. Just need a little bit more air under it. Hurd just got in there at the last minute to knock that one away.
Dagenhart coming in with 7 touchdown passes. And just under 1,500 yards passing for the season. The junior from Westford Academy. Dagenhart to throw on third down. He has plenty of time. Throws underneath. It's Spencer Gilliam, and Gilliam's going to be close. He got the first down. He got to the 10-yard line. Spencer Gilliam, the speedy sophomore from Texas.
And this is just having time to throw the football. Great job by the offensive line up front. And Gilliam knows where he needs to be. But that was a situation where Dagenhart had time to read the entire field and get it down to Gilliam for a first down.
He's running a crossing route and coming all the way across the field. That gives you an idea of how much time Dagenhart had where he threw that ball. Gilliam had come all the way across the field. Dom Cozier on first down, and Cozier tripped up, slides forward to the 7-yard line. It'll be second and goal from the 7 for Holy Cross.
Nick Wheeler is the leader of this defense. He is the active, number 2 active sack leader for a career in NCAA football right now. The linebacker is Iannelli, the leading tackler in that defense. Hurd's already made a big play. And Abu Darami Soare is a talented defensive back and kick returner.
Bunch formation to the near side. A lot of open space on the far side. Pete Oliver, the lone setback. Oliver gets the call. Oliver runs through a tackle and gets inside the 5 down to the 3-yard line. And that was, again, One of those challenges that the coaching staff put out there, one of them they put was on Pete Oliver. Yards after contact. They want him to get more yards after contact. They showed him some statistics, and they said he really took that to heart. He is a tough customer.
You put a challenge out there, Oliver. I mean, just look at the guy. He is a weight room dude right there. He can move. Big legs. Needs to push the pile. And when they challenge him, yeah, he's going to take that challenge.
His father, Jeff Oliver, the head of strength and conditioning at Holy Cross. Former standout player at Boston College. Played in the NFL with the New York Jets.
Bob Chesney didn't like what he saw there. The offense is taking a little while to set up. He's going to call a timeout, sort things out.
Third and goal at the four. Brenna Wilson is with us down at field level. Brenna. We'll get to Brenna. We'll get to Brenna. So it's third and goal for Holy Cross at the four-yard line as the Crusaders' opening drive of the game. The defense did what they needed to do, a three and out. Mm. And the offense gets that big run. You know, one of the things that Bob Chesney said, he saw a quote, I think it was from the Duke football coach, about offensive linemen. He said, it's the only position on a football team that there are no stats for. Every other position has stats, tackles for a loss, sacks, yards per carry, passing. The offensive line, there are no stats for those guys. They are the ultimate team players. Their only goal is to win. Well, he shared that quote with his offensive line this week and said, guys, it's on you. It's on your back. Oliver in the backfield. Oliver gets the carry. Oliver to the end zone for the touchdown. And the Crusaders have struck first. Power football between the tackles. Straight ahead, hat on hat.
And it was Bowler again who led the way. He was almost like a lead blocker here, pulling from his guard position. And he got the big block to spring Peter Oliver. That's a heck of a start there.
Yeah, second rushing touchdown of the season for Pete Oliver. What a great athlete Pete Oliver is, too. He was a hockey and lacrosse player at St. John's in high school, as well as football. Derek Ng's kick is up and through. 10:25 to play here in the opening quarter. The Crusaders, on the backs of their offensive line, have struck for seven.
Sullivan Group is an insurance and risk management services firm based in Worcester for over 60 years.
With the tremendous growth of life sciences both globally and locally, we've dedicated our resources to build a strong, knowledgeable, and responsive team to meet the insurance and risk management needs of this dynamic industry.
Our personal lines team will make sure your home, your car, your personal belongings, and most importantly, your family are protected.
The Sullivan Group has the resources, the carriers, and the coverage to protect you and your business.
Hi, I'm Rich Salmon, GM of Bertera Nissan. Come join us for our 2019 clearance event.
This is the all-new 2019 redesigned Nissan Altima, now available in all-wheel drive. Here we have the 2019 Nissan Kicks. Sporty, stylish, and incredibly fun to drive.
If you work for UMass, Fallon, St. Gobain's, Wyman Gordon, or any of Worcester's largest employers, we'll take care of you with an additional discount up to $500.
Bertera Nissan, Route 20, Auburn, Massachusetts.
All right, welcome back. This is Power Football here from Holy Cross. And Bowler had a big block on an earlier run. Jack Bowler, 68C in the middle there, springs Peter Oliver, who takes that first contact and then gets into the end zone as well. So a good power running attack for Holy Cross, set up by Cozier. A big pass to Gilliam to get a first down and extend that drive, and then Peter Oliver finishing it behind that offensive line. Challenge to the offensive line, challenge accepted at least so far right now, Kev.
And this is a close-knit group. I saw the offensive line on Wednesday. They were all in one of the meeting rooms together. It was just the O-line, and they were watching film by themselves. They were watching practice film by themselves. It's a tight-knit group, and they hold each other accountable.
Did they have any snacks with them?
No snacks. This was all business.
Wow.
And then Chris Smith was coming in later, their coach, the line coach. Maybe he was bringing some, but this was a group that was all business.
I figured if you were hanging out with the offensive line, there might be snacks.
Look at this. Onside kick. Holy Cross recovers. The Crusaders recover. Grant Holloman hauls it in on the onside kick.
Let's
and that's a hallmark of a Bob Chesney team. is they have several different onside kicks. They are not afraid to use them. Try to get an extra possession. There's some discussion now with the officials. It looked from the naked eye, certainly, that it was good.
The moving on the field is that the Holy Cross player caught the ball at the 9-yard line. Excuse me, at the 44-yard line. That's illegal touching.
First down. They're saying they got it before 10 yards. I thought it looked like he had
under
gone
further
10
review.
Yards.
It was very, very close, and I don't know if this is something that they want to look at, but I think they are going to take a look in the review area here because they spotted it on the far side at the 44-yard line. So it looked like the receiver, or number two, Honelman, touched it right at the 45, which would be right there.
Right. That's what I thought. From the naked eye, again, up here, it looked like it was at the 45.
Right.
And it looked like he did wait that extra just, you know, half second to get the extra yard that he needed for it.
They're going to rule on the field with the spot did not go 10 yards, and so they'll have to see something to overturn that, which will be difficult from a Holy Cross perspective. It might be tough to overturn.
But this is the aggressive nature. This is Bob Chesney's nature. They, you know, defensively, their teams are always very aggressive. Offensively, they're going to go for it on fourth down at times. They're going to kick. They're going to go for these onside kicks, and they have several of them in their arsenal, several different onside kicks, and they're not afraid to use them.
Well, they certainly had it.
Time.
Yeah, they certainly had it, and they had Colgate off guard there that they could make a play because the Raiders weren't ready for that on their special team side.
I don't know that there's a head coach who enjoys special teams as much as Bob Chesney.
No.
He loves the kicking game. He loves special teams. I mean, even just punting, not even just
He talks about it
kick
more
off.
Than – yeah, you're right. He talks about it, and he talks about it from an expert standpoint because I don't know if he's read a bunch of books, but I mean, he came from Kicker U just down the street here at Assumption with Cole Tracy and some of the great kickers they've had there. But you know, he's really become kind of a specialist of specialists because he's really a guru of the kicking game.
Yeah, it was when he was an assistant coach up at Norwich. He was an assistant coach at Norwich, and the head coach said to him, "You're in charge of special teams. You're in charge of the punters." So he got books. He said, "I got three or four books I would read every night. I would read about technique and how to do things differently to get more explosion off your foot." He goes, "Then I would go out in the morning, and I would punt the ball. I would kick the ball, and I would try to put into practice what I just read about." And so he said, "I just really enjoyed it, and have always been that way." When you go to his practices, he'll punt. Yeah. He'll be punting the guys. He'll be kicking. He really does. It's something that he enjoys. It's not, for most coaches, it is not a labor of love. It is for Bob Chesney. Well, Max Durrell for Holy Cross backup center, he's wearing number 69 today. Nick Wheeler, the defensive lineman for Colgate, he is wearing 69 today. Not their normal numbers. Brenna Wilson has that story for us. Brenna?
Yeah, Max Durrell and Nick Wheeler both attended Christian Brothers School in St. Louis, Missouri. They're both wearing 69 today in honor of their high school teammate, John Chamberlain, who passed away earlier this week. It's a special moment for these guys who may be playing on opposite side of the field, but they're playing for something bigger.
Thank you, Brenna. Yeah, certainly
no
an emotional
play.
Week for those two young men.
By the kicking team.
And all,
first down for Colgate at the 44-yard
all of their former
line.
Teammates and friends who are feeling the loss at this time. The play was not overturned, so the Colgate offense has good field position at the Holy Cross 44-yard line. This will be a play that will be talked about, but you know, this is another challenge that this defense will have to rise up to, and they've faced this a lot so far.
It's a play you make to try to make a play, but it also shows that you have confidence in your defense that you can defend the short field.
Brenneman, quarterback now with a two-back set. He's got Twyman and Matthews both back there. Matthews is a 1,000-yard rusher. Brenneman's going to keep it himself, and he's brought down by Whitley. They mark him inside the 40 down to the 39-yard line, so a pickup of 5 on first down for Brenneman.
You know, we talk about the defensive line as being very tough and, you know, maybe undersized but tough, but you've got athletes like Whitley who can track down a quarterback and already knock down a pass in this game.
They are some big dudes down there, and they get after it. Modak and Ebo on the interior. Whitley going from the two-point stance. Brenneman has time, has a lot of time. Here comes Whitley, flushes him out of the pocket. Brenneman's got some space, and here comes the hold. There's going to be a hold on 68.
Modak drew it.
Brenneman with the keeper, flag on the play.
Till that time, Holy Cross kind of designed a little bit, just a four-man rush, but a little bit different. They moved their defensive tackle, Ebo, really all the way out to the end position and tried to run Bentley.
Illegal block in the back. Offense.
There's the illegal
number
block
68.
Call against
10-yard penalty. Replay second down.
Defensively for Holy Cross, that front group. Ebo, one of those leaders, one of the seniors, one of the guys who've been around, and Whitley and Modak and others in that mix. Liam Doran and Jake Dobbs, a sophomore and a freshman helping lead that defense, and Lang and Riley and Stefanik, they just get after the football.
And of course their head coach, or their coach, the line coach, Mike Pucko, has him frothing at the mouth and ready to go, and that's a trademark of Pucko coach groups, is they just will get after you and they will bang you and smack you in the mouth. Kuznetsov with the tackle, another one of those talented guys up front.
Yeah, this was a really, this looked like it was designed up really well for Colgate. They had some big bodies and numbers on this side of the field, but Kuznetsov and Doran kind of just disrupted it and were able to get to the ball carrier.
So now it brings up a third down and 11. Brenneman from the shotgun, two receivers to the far side, one to the near. Brenneman changing the play.
Whitley's job, he's just coming right at the quarterback here.
Holy Cross with three down linemen. They'll blitz from the outside, and a good job as they hand that ball off up the middle. Alex Matthews, the 1,000-yard rusher, getting his first touch of the game, and he's brought down after a very short game.
Well, they've got the special teams unit huddled up over there on the far sideline. They are going to bring him in. I almost thought if you run there on third and long, you're going to set up a four-down situation, but they're going to try to pin the Crusaders deep here and see if their defense can make a play.
That's a big, big stop for this Holy Cross defense, because you go from the emotion of you think you got the onside kick. Nope, you didn't get it. And now Colgate has great field position, and you're going to force a three and out? That's incredible. They gained, what'd they gain? 3 yards total on that. And it's a high-hanging kick. Holy Cross lets it hit, and it goes into the end zone for a touchback. So you look at the net of what happened. That's a great defensive stand by the Crusaders. The offense gets another crack at it when we come back.
Kevin, meet your father.
Kevin.
Kevin.
Kevin. Kevin.
Kevin.
Kevin.
Kevin.
Kevin.
Trusted advice for life.
Kevin, how's your mom?
Thank you.
Life well planned. See what a Raymond James financial advisor can do for you.
Bison pride is the feeling that you get when you're with all of your Nichols friends and you're rooting for your team and your school and your community.
Even though we are a smaller school, you feel the big school vibe here.
Providing our customers with the highest level of quality, service, and value. Pucci's Fine Jewelry, 205 West Boylston Street in West Boylston.
Welcome back, everyone. Holy Cross with a big, big defensive stand. Remember, Colgate took possession on the Holy Cross 44-yard line. Crusaders force a three and out. The punt goes into the end zone, and now their offense takes over on their own 20. That's a big stop early in this game for a team, Colgate, coming in 1-7, just looking to gain some confidence, looking to get their feet under them. They've struggled mightily this year.
You know, again, you make that decision with confidence in your defense if the onside kick doesn't go. It didn't happen. You've got confidence that your defense makes a play. They do. And now can the offense capitalize?
Here's Cozier, straight up the middle. Dom Cozier, first down and more. Bursts into the secondary. Cozier gets a block downfield from Tenio Ayeni and gets across midfield into Colgate territory, down to the 40 of the Raiders.
Well, Dom Cozier's having a huge game.
But Jack Bowler is having just as big a game because he, again, is the first man through the hole. He takes two blocks, takes on two defenders, and springs Cozier, who is in pace to have a monster game right now.
That's a 40-yard run from Dom Cozier. He's close to 100 yards already. Here's Cozier again. Waits for a blocks to develop and gets inside the 40 down to the 38-yard line, a gain of two. As the clock runs, 7:05 remaining here in the first quarter, and Dom Cozier nearing 100 yards rushing.
Yeah, he's having a day. That time the Colgate front seven did a nice job to hold him back a little bit there and close the hole.
Three wide receivers to the top of the screen. Cozier, the lone setback. Connor Dagenhart, Westford Academy. 6'6", 214 pounds. Here goes Cozier, and a great job closing on the play. Cozier looked like he was going to be able to turn the corner and get the first down, but Ionelli got him, the leading tackler in the Patriot League.
Yeah, 62 tackles coming in and, you know, doing a job and making a play on the outset, because Cozier, with his speed, can really turn it up. And Kev, he does have 105. He's got 107 yards and seven carries already.
Incredible. Now a third down for Holy Cross. Third and six. They need to get to the Colgate 30. Oliver's in the backfield. Colgate, oh, then Holy Cross moved. Colgate was showing blitz. The Crusaders move up front. They'll move them back 5 yards. So now you're looking at a third down and 11.
False start. Offense, number 63. 5 yard penalty, third down.
Holy Cross, 127 yards on the ground between Cozier and Oliver already here in the first quarter. Saw Steve Silva prior to the game and said we still bring up Steve Silva's name a lot on the broadcast because, you know, when else have you had a guy consistently power running the football? You go back to guys like Silva when the running game was a big time part of this offense.
Well, he was a threat out of the backfield to catch it as well. He was a great receiver and a kick returner. Derek Mountain split out. Watch if they try to go deep to Mountain. Dagenhart has time. Now he's flushed out of the pocket. Now fires as a flag comes down. It was intended for Mountain. Mountain got it. Thought he was out of bounds. One official said he caught it. The other one said he was out of bounds. But a flag again on the far side of the field in the area of holding.
Pass.
Well, you can credit this play to Abu Darami Sware.
Offense.
This penalty against
number
the Crusaders
63.
Going to march.
Penalty is declined.
Declined. So be a fourth
result
down.
Of the play is
because
fourth down.
They wanted Ieni on that play, but Darami Sware really made a play and did not free him up. Let's go down to Brenna Wilson on the sideline.
Holy Cross wearing their white helmets today. They haven't worn white helmets since the mid-70s. The team telling me prior to the game that, you know, they had the black helmets last year. They want to try something new this year, and they're trying to make it look a little bit like those helmets from the past. If you look at the Ring of Honor on the side, they're trying to get those white HC helmets out on the field.
All right, thank you, Brennan. Well, the uniforms are so much a part of every football program now. Holy Cross is going to punt it away. Wilkinson has been fantastic. This is Derek Ng, who tries to hang it, and Holy Cross downs it at the 1 yard line.
Terrell Prince.
Oh, man. He is all over the field on special teams.
Yeah.
And it was Doran. Prince got it, whacked it back into play, and Doran was right there standing on the one to receive it. What a punt from Ng.
I'll tell you what. Terrell Prince is a guy, they didn't have him in the Navy game, and Bob Chesney started talking about him to us right there after week one. I really needed him. We need him for, like, punt coverage. And he's just shown why they have so much confidence in the young guy week in and week out. Makes another play there.
And again, the coach that loves special teams so much, and their special teams comes up with a big play. So now Colgate from their own end zone. Brenneman in the shotgun. Matthews gets the call. It's Twyman. He is stacked up after a short gain of one.
Carried by number 44, Alex Matthews. Let's go,
six. The Crusaders, Kevin Buccheroni was under the pile there, one of the guys making the stops. And Bob Chesney's eyes light up when he talks about Kevin Buccheroni. He loves him, talks about how much fun he is to be around. all energy. He said he picks everyone up on the field all day in practice. Bucciarone making a big play. Brenneman going deep over the middle, and a mix-up on the play there with Nick Gill. Nick Gill's a Massachusetts native, went to BC High.
That one
well
just
covered.
Yeah, you know, he had Reynolds downfield and good coverage, and, you know, Brenneman, you know, he was dinged up, missed a couple of games completely and missed a bunch of other time in other games, and, you know, may not be fully healthy as he kind of looked like he might be hobbling a little bit there.
Yeah, he had a foot injury in William and Mary. So a big third down and nine. Brenneman rolls to the left, design roll, now fires, and it's complete, and it's a first down. That's a big, big play for Colgate. Garrett Oakley on the receiving end, but gets the Raiders out of their own end zone and gets them a first down as well.
Big play. And Brenneman still shows you he can sling the rock around, gets it to Oakley. And well, Brenneman's a guy who was one of these quarterbacks who was invited to the Manning camp this past year. So that's a pretty big honor. And shows a little bit of what kind of skills he has to be an instructor and a quarterback at the Manning camps.
Yeah, they had over 40 quarterbacks, college quarterbacks from around the country, and a lot of big names. And he was gushing about it. Now there's another first down throw as he hooks up with Michael Kane, his big tight end.
Yeah, this just able again to step in and throw here. Gets a pretty good pocket from his offensive line, and Kane's wide open. He drills it in there.
Brenneman throws that right when he's making his break. You could see it on that replay. The minute Kane took that first half step on his break, the ball was out.
Just his sixth catch of the season.
Because you got a tight end. Now the defensive backs can close on him quickly, but Brenneman gets it out quickly. Brenneman again, and that should be offensive interference.
Flag does.
Oh, here it
in.
Is. Now it comes down now, because that was tremendous defense from John Smith. He had the inside position on that the whole way, and the receiver ends up playing the role of the defensive back.
Yeah, Smith, couple of picks this year, and it looked like he had pretty good coverage here, but let's see. Colgate's already kind of marching back, so this should be against the Raiders.
There is no foul for defensive pass interference.
Nope, no call.
The result of the play is an incomplete pass. Second down.
Are they going to say it was uncatchable? Oh, mercy.
Well, Bob Chesney's,
it's holding at the
Bob
very
Chesney's
least.
Not happy about that. He's talking to the side judge over here. Second and long. There was certainly contact. If it had gone the other way, that would have been defensive pass interference.
Easily. So here's Brenneman on second down. Brenneman has some time, steps into the throw, complete to the tight end again. He goes back to his big tight end, and another grab by Kane, and it's the same route.
Yeah, and
Holy corner route.
Holy Cross brought both their middle linebackers in and on a delayed blitz there, but it was picked up by the Colgate offensive line and running backs, and that gave Brenneman plenty of time to hit the tight end.
Colgate's got a big offensive line. They got a great one too, and Jack Botovanic, the left guard. They talked a lot about him, Holy Cross did.
Well, there's that
Diaco. Diaco, the big tight end, gets the carry, and he just powers his way forward for 8 yards. What an athlete he is, Diaco.
Diaco, I mean, you've mentioned him running out of the Wildcat. He's got 6 carries from a tight end spot. Averaged about 4 yards a touch, and did more than that here on first down.
6'4 and 235, just a good athlete. Second down and 2. 2:10 to play in the first quarter, 7-0 Holy Cross. Colgate driving at the Crusader 40. Brenneman with the pocket collapsing around him, fires out, and it is complete. Doran was in coverage.
Yeah, Twyman, the running back, got out there. Doran, you don't see him a lot in pass coverage, but he's out there, and again, good time for the quarterback to set his feet and fire. And he's starting to get into the flow a little bit here, is Brenneman.
Doran fifth on this team in tackles for Holy Cross. Holy Cross with four players with 40-plus tackles. This is a very active defense. And they're showing blitz. Stefanik's coming, one of the leaders in sacks. And Stefanik makes the tackle. Oof. Holy Cross almost ripped that ball out. Stefanik did a great job holding his ground. Walter Reynolds almost ripped it free.
Yeah, Stefanik rips off of the lead running back and then just, it's almost like a wrestling move to take down the ball carrier.
Stefanik's one of the leaders on this defense. He's a guy that's been out there a lot over his career. Brenneman off of play action. Goes deep down the middle, and it's picked off. Intercepted by Holy Cross. The tip drill.
Yep.
And I'll tell you, it was a play ago. Reynolds got in there defensively on the run. This time he gets the interception off the tip, and the Crusaders defense forces another turnover, their 16th of the season.
Incredible. And again, it's Riley that tips this one. Riley goes up like he's a power forward trying to get a rebound, tips it. Look at this. One-handed grab from Reynolds. A big turnover for the Crusaders. They've been opportunistic defensively and trying to find a matchup downfield. Riley has that size. He was there. Holy Cross had some help over the middle, and Riley's able to match up pretty well against some of these taller receivers and tight ends, and tips it up to his cornerback to make the play.
First interception of the season for Reynolds. The eighth as a team. And the Colgate defense stops the run for a 1 yard loss.
Jared Petrichik got into the backfield and fought off his block for a tackle for a loss.
Second down and 12 for Holy Cross. As the clock runs, they don't have to run another play if they don't want to before the end of the quarter. 15 seconds remaining in the quarter. Dagenhart to throw. He's got Cozier. Cozier's got some speed, or some room rather. Stumbles out of his break, and he goes down about a yard short of a first down. That time they just used that rush against Colgate. Cozier slips out into the flat, picks up a nice gain of 10 yards, and that's the end of the first quarter. When we come back, it'll be third and one for the Crusaders. Holy Cross in front of Colgate, 7-0.
Milford Federal Bank has been part of our community's history, honoring local traditions, supporting local causes, and caring about local issues since 1887. While many community banks have come and gone through the years, we're still here, committed to our loyal customers and the communities we serve. We're Milford Federal Bank, your community, your bank, your choice. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
For you guys to start taking circumferences.
See where it's marked on beats 1 and 3 in that measure?
Okay, good.
Let's go one more time from the beginning.
Here we go.
Yeah.
All right.
Well, it was a big first quarter for the Holy Cross rushing attack, specifically Dom Cozier, 105 yards on the ground, and he broke a few. Behind that offensive line, Jack Bowler and company getting things done. Got a block from Mountain there to Springham. And another one downfield from Ianni. The Crusaders aggressively attacking on the running game. They just threw four passes in the first quarter to Dagenhart. And his fourth was to Cozier. He's accounted for the bulk of the offense, has Dom so far.
Yeah, Dom Cozier came into the game second in the Patriot League in rushing yards per game at over 56 yards per game. And he's certainly upping his average today. And, you know, again, it can be deceiving when you look at league games versus the total season. But this is what Holy Cross wanted to do, run the ball effectively and rotate some of those guys in there. Cozier's a guy that did so much work in the weight room. He is so strong, gained about 15 pounds of muscle. There's Peter Oliver. Bob Chesney was talking about just the size of his legs. He said he was sitting in my office the other day, and I was looking at the size of his legs like, wow.
Now, Peter Oliver, short yardage situation, and fights through the first tackle to pick up the yardage. They've got big guys, big, strong physical guys. Cozier, as you mentioned, getting stronger. He gets the touch here, and there's the strength of the legs.
Runs through a tackle in the backfield. Should have gone for a loss of four. Instead, Cozier turns it into a gain of five. That's what all the work with Chris Grotzky in the weight room does for you. Grotzky has done a phenomenal job with this team.
Yeah, just picking up yards where it shouldn't happen. And that's, you know, we talked about that in the preseason with the weights and the specific training they were doing. Max Terrell came off the field there. He put up a finger, said he needs one play off, but he kind of hobbled off. Something to watch in the offensive line.
Dagenhart has time, has a lot of time. Now he runs out of the pocket. Dagenhart's got room to run. He fires it to the freshman, Asante. Ayer Asante has a first down for Holy Cross. How about the time Dagenhart had and no penalty?
Yeah, getting a ton of time and getting to kind of create a little bit. He extends it with his legs, getting the outside. Really good job of pass protection on the edge from Grady Smith, number 77 there on the right tackle spot.
Handoff on first down, Cozier following that big offensive line, and he plows across midfield into Colgate territory down to the 49, a pickup of five on first down.
Now Cozier had a 100-yard game earlier this year, a couple of weeks ago, and he's got another one here, and it's physical. It's between the tackles, most of his yardage.
Here's Cozier again, straight up the gut. That's going right between the guard and the center, and that's another first down for Holy Cross.
Man, I'll tell you what. I mean, they're coming out. The Crusaders are run first. It's everything they've talked about wanting to do over the last, I don't know, 10 years?
Yes.
And they're doing it here. And they've had some games, Central Connecticut a couple of years ago, where they ran the ball a ton and things like that, and they have to slow them down here for a as they were getting guys off the field and had to allow so to set the play. But
well, they're going to wear this Colgate defense down a little bit if they can continue this pace. And here's Cozier again on first down, pickup of 6 yards on first down. Nothing fancy, straight ahead, drive blocking from the offensive line.
Yeah, and, you know, again, it's not going down on first contact either. Running hard in through tackles, running north-south. We got it going right now. We'll get a break. Peter Oliver comes in.
Dagenhart from the shotgun with Oliver back there with him. It's Oliver. Oliver driving after contact. It was a defensive lineman. It was Wheeler who wrapped him up. And Oliver took him forward for about a yard and a half.
Yeah, and Wheeler had to get help to bring him down. Here he is, the sack man, and the guy who is the preseason Patriot League player of the year. And Peter Oliver took him for an extra yard or so. They're going to look at that one on film and be happy about it. It's only a couple of yards, but the way he got him.
And again, it's going to overtime wear this defensive line down. When you can continue to do what they're doing here, they're not allowing because they run this hurry-up, quote-unquote hurry-up offense. They can wait, but they get right away to the line of scrimmage. Here's Oliver with
Ball's
a first
out.
Run, fumble! And let's see, it looked like Colgate was on top of it. It looked like Colgate recovered. It's a wrestling match under there now.
There's a fight for it.
Yeah.
Could have been Brosh.
Yep, it is.
Brosh has it. That's a big, big play because the Crusaders were rolling and it was knocked away by Gaitner. And Brosh was able to hang on. Gertner, number 40, just gets his head on the ball. And they could not wrestle away from Brosh on the ground.
Oh, that's a killer. Just because of the way that drive was going, that it was just straight ahead. Where it was the old board drill. They were knocking Colgate back off the ball. And they were gaining 4 to 6 yards per rush, straight ahead.
Yeah, just straight flowing against the Raiders. And that defense needed something like that. And they made it happen.
Yep.
College football here on Charter TV3 is presented by the law offices of Joseph J. Cariglia and by Bay State Savings Bank.
All right, well, you look at the first quarter statistics and time of possession. Holy Cross had about doubled up Colgate in time of possession. It was 9:58 to 5:02, so about 10 minutes to 5 minutes in time of possession. They were controlling the clock in that drive. They were doing everything they wanted to do, but Bob Chesney talked about ball security a lot during the week and what they have to do and how they have to hold on to the football, and that was something that bit them last week against Harvard.
Yeah, you know, and overall, outside of last week when they turned it over four times, the Crusaders have been pretty good about hanging on to the football. And but that one, that's a killer. Puts it back on that defense for Holy Cross to come out and get a three and out. There is a review going on now, and it might be to see, you know, it's great look there. It's clear recovery from Brosh. So it might have been to see if
the loop in the field stands.
Recovery.
Colgate ball. First down. Maybe a timeout on the field.
Recovery from the linebacker from Colgate. And the Raiders get a little bit extra time to sort out their offense and get going here from the 32-yard line.
So now the teams go back to the sidelines.
Now there's still a...
We just got stuck in quicksand here.
There's still a media timeout.
We'll take a break and be back with more from Fit and Field. You are watching exclusive coverage of Holy Cross football on Charter TV3.
Elizabeth Warren talks about the 1%. She is the 1%. Now, if you really are so concerned about the little guy and the average guy and the middle-income person, where are you? Too bad that our own Congressman Jim McGovern doesn't have the fortitude to stand up and speak on behalf of the people in his community. They all go to Congress with no money in their pocket, and they all leave there as millionaires. How does that happen?
Welcome back, everyone. Colgate looking to respond here as they trail Holy Cross 7-0. Brenna Wilson, the third member of our broadcast crew, is with us down at field level. Brenna?
You know, we talked about how Chesney was stressing ball security, and that's been something that he's been stressing for the last few years he's been up here. They've been doing drills throughout practice, you know, throwing water on the ball, having guys run and blitz at the guy that's catching the ball, just to make sure that they have every possible scenario at hand practice so that when they get out here, it should be kind of normal. Guys.
Thank you, Brenna. Yeah, one of the things that it's a great point right there is Bob Chesney tries to simulate game situations, game scenarios, and does it better than almost anyone, whether it's with the kickers and icing them with timeouts and having the whole team yelling at him. And Gill just got drilled. He got the first down, and then he got stood up and just peppered.
Yeah, but he got the job done, and really it was just Reynolds out there that needed to step up and make a play against the run, and he did. But, man, Gill, he's running tall, and Reynolds just comes in. Good form tackle. He breaks the pop, and then he keeps his arms and wrapped around him to bring him down.
Massachusetts kid, as we talked about, from Plymouth and BC High. Brenneman hands it off to Matthews. Matthews is a big, strong back, and Matthews gets the corner. Run out of bounds by Lang. See where they spot him.
There's a lot of energy now on that far sideline. They go from
Lang's
down. Lang's hurt.
That's a big loss for Holy Cross. The second leading tackler on this team, Lang, he's been playing with a banged up ankle. And he may have just re-aggravated it. Well, we'll take a timeout on the field and be back with more Holy Cross football right after this.
I'm District Attorney Joe Early Jr., and I'm proud to partner with Charter Communications with our pledge to help raise awareness that bullying should not be tolerated. From local school students, here's our message.
Step up so others won't get stepped on. Take a stand and lend a hand.
We need to foster safe environments for students in their schools and communities. Join the Anti-Bully Crusade. Take a stand to lend a hand. Don't be a bully.
Presented by the Law Offices of Joseph J. Coriglio.
Our founders would have never seen this coming.
Spygate?
No.
Deflategate?
No.
What then?
Benji!
Benji knocks down any obstacle that he can get his paws on and tackles every high interest rate that gets in between us and our customers, which is why he made the Bay State Savings Bank team.
You're right. They would have never seen Benji coming, but I'm sure they're glad he came.
Bay State Savings Bank. We take banking personally.
Welcome back, everyone. Holy Cross in front of Colgate. 7-0, still 10:36 remaining here in the first half. A lot of time left in this first half, and you mentioned about the momentum, and Colgate had it. They got the fumble recovery, a couple big plays on offense, and then you've had some timeouts. We've had some stoppages in play. Can they continue with that momentum? And Holy Cross losing one of their defensive leaders, Joe Lang, came in second on the team in tackles with 50 tackles.
His helmet's off on the near sideline, but he's moving around on his feet.
Lang ninth in the Patriot League in tackles per game. Colgate's gonna go on the ground, and it looks like, we'll see where they spotted.
They have a pretty good spot.
Yeah, they
the
did. I was gonna say short, but I agree with you. The guy on the far side looked to me like he was giving it to him.
Jason Modak got that first contact. Let's see,
No, the guy on our side.
They haven't sticks yet, so they're short. They have to get it to the 41.
The headline's
shot.
Yeah, the headline's been had it back a little bit more, I think, where you and I were looking at it. Third and inches. Matthews in the backfield. Run as well at quarterback. He hands it off to Matthews, and Matthews gets forward for the first down. And the Colgate offensive line doing their job, and the Raiders' drive continues.
Yeah, he just drives ahead behind Ben Bonenberger and company up there, and they got enough of a surge.
All right. So Brenneman with the offense, sends a man in motion. They fake the sweep. Brenneman under pressure, gets rid of it, and it's complete. And he's making a living going to the tight end as Stefanik trying to punch it out and can't do it. Kane with a big gainer. Stefanik looked like Marvin Hagler throwing uppercuts.
He was throwing uppercuts there at the end. How about that? Kane's got three grabs already, and you know, he's the go-to guy. There's the uppercut, uppercut.
Carlos Garcia down the boys club. The boxing coach would love that.
Throw the bombito if you have to.
Well, that's the poise of Brenneman, you know, the preseason player of the year, because he had a defensive lineman coming right into his face, and he was able to buy just a half step of time, knew where his tight end was going to be. And Twyman, and Stefanik's trying to rip that one out too. Stefanik is just a ball hawk.
He's going after. He's going after that football. Twyman was running downhill on him and was able to pick up a yard or two after contact.
Beautiful day here for the fans tailgating.
School's out. It's a Saturday. Crowd's filling in still.
Second and 7 from the 21-yard line for the Raiders. The handoff is to Oki on the sweep, and
that's a great play.
Just couldn't get out of the grasp. That is great play on the defensive line. That's Thiessen, the freshman. Thiessen was a monster against Syracuse. He had his coming out party against Syracuse. He was great. Kiesling.
Yeah.
Thomas Kiesling.
They love this guy. They love this freshman. Yeah, you went Thomas the train there.
I did.
And Kiesling comes right through. The guys that are making plays on the defensive line probably, if you ask their coaches, might not have been the guys that they thought would be making them this early in their careers.
Oh, definitely. Brenneman's going to run. That's a design run. And Whitley. He gets dropped by Whitley.
Whitley started on the other side of the field, tracked all the way back in here. He's a guy they expected to make plays. He made plays last season. And the Minichug guy, Western Mass, showing out here.
And you had Liam Anderson, who turned him inside into the pursuit. Anderson was a quarterback in high school, quarterback and safety. Was a safety here last year. They put some pounds on him, thought that he could be a linebacker in this defense. And lo and behold, here he is. And this is a big field goal. This is a 37-yard field goal. Plenty of leg, though.
Yeah, Puzzy's a good one. He is a good one. Chris Puzzy can really take care of business back there. And they get Colgate on the board.
Elizabeth Warren talks about the 1%. She is the 1%. Now, if you really are so concerned about the little guy and the average guy and the middle-income person, where are you? Too bad that our own Congressman Jim McGovern doesn't have the fortitude to stand up and speak on behalf of the people in his community. They all go to Congress with no money in their pocket, and they all leave there as millionaires. How does that happen?
Local news from Central Massachusetts for Central Massachusetts. Reporters in the field and an in-depth local forecast. Worcester News Tonight on Charter TV3.
Welcome back, everyone. So Chris Puzzy, the field goal kicker for Colgate, came in 2 of 4 in field goal attempts this season, and that 37-yarder is the long for the season so far for Puzzy. But you saw the accuracy and the leg size, and this is what you talked about. Family weekend up here at Holy Cross, and a great crowd on hand to watch this Holy Cross Colgate game, and there are still tons of people out tailgating too.
There usually are.
Enjoying it. And we hope that they'll continue to tailgate after the game so you and I can get down there and maybe get ourselves a hot dog.
A snack.
And a ginger ale.
How about a snack? Puzzy, though, 27th career field goal made. 27 of 33. He's got a high percentage, and he's sixth all-time at Colgate. So he's a guy who they can lean on back there, even though he's only kicked his third made field goal here of the season.
The kickoff is deep, and Holy Cross will not return it.
Yeah, good angle there from Puzzy. They're not going to let Gilliam or Asante try to hurt him back there in the kick return game. Good speed back there for Holy Cross, so they get the touchback. And now, you know, if you're Holy Cross, you've got Connor Degenhardt. He's just 3 of 5 here in the early going, but you've got some success running the football. And he hasn't had to really throw the ball, has Degenhardt, early on, because the offensive line has controlled the line of scrimmage and really pushed the pile.
Miles Alexander in the backfield for Holy Cross. Bob Chesney said he expect to see Jordan Forrest. Alexander, they want to use all their running backs because they all bring something different to the table. Alexander stood up, and he's driven back and dropped. But yep, they all bring something different to the table, and he wants to keep them fresh and really pound it.
Yeah, nice job defensively from Colgate that time. They figured something out. But Alexander can really play, and it's good that he's healthy. Gowan making a play there, but he hasn't been healthy for a lot of the season. And Forrest is a guy that they're very high on. They are deep, as you mentioned early on in this running back pool. Seemed like the whistle took forever to blow there on that last play.
I don't know that Holy Cross was pleased. Degenhardt going deep. Asante is there, and he's got it. Connor Degenhardt up top to Asante. Bob Chesney's been talking about that. We have to take some shots deep down the field. Well, they did it there, and the freshman hauls it in.
And Degenhardt's got a strong arm, you know, and he makes a good throw here, and Asante has to go up and get it over Gruber. He's got him beat, has to come back on the ball a little bit, and then has to hang on, because Gruber almost strips that free. Big throw and catch.
And now it's Alexander. Miles Alexander picks up 4 yards, maybe five on first down.
Be good for Holy Cross if they can get Alexander going and really have him be the third guy with Oliver and Cozier. I mean, he was the guy early in the year. He got the bulk of the touches against Navy with Cozier down and had a good game against Navy, but they really haven't had all three guys and Forrest healthy at the same time and in it.
No, 5'11", 200 pounds, Alexander dropped for a loss of 4 on the play by Iannelli.
Iannelli can get after it, man. He's always around the ball. He's a big guy, and he moves really, really well for that size.
Brings up a big third down. Holy Cross is on the Colgate 32. They need to get to the 24-yard line for a first down. Maybe four down territory from where they are here. Three wide receivers to the near side. Alexander's the lone running back. Colgate showing blitz. Dagenhart now backs off, looks to the sideline as he changes things up. 3 seconds on the play clock, down to 2. Dagenhart going deep for Asante again, and he holds it in for the touchdown. Dagenhart to Ayer Asante, 32 yards on the scoring strike. Another big one for Holy Cross in this offense.
Wow, what a play, what a throw, what a grab. Dagenhart had the heat coming, Wheeler was coming. And you know, good credit on that left tackle spot. I think he could have held Wheeler and he had to let him go. There was no call, and that's a good no call because I think the offensive lineman made a smart play. Dagenhart had to get in and rip it, and he did, and Asante makes another play.
Derek Ng is on for the point after. 15 of 16 on PATs this season for Ng, the sophomore. Well, Dagenhart airing it out that drive. Two big strikes to the freshman Asante, the second one for the touchdown. And this offense right now, by air and by land, they are getting it done.
Now let's get a look. Heat's coming here. Foley's got to just kind of, he had to just kind of turn him loose a little bit, just get enough of Wheeler, and wow, what a throw to the back shoulder of Asante. Dagenhart has to make this throw. He sees that heat coming, he knows he's going to get hit. And he goes up, and Asante makes a play on the football against a really good defensive back in Colin Hurd.
You know what, too? You see Dagenhart, when he first got the ball, he looked to the right. Just for a half second, looked to the right, freezes the safety, then comes back into the man coverage, and you can see the safety a little late getting over there. It's because Dagenhart looked him off for that half second, just looked him off enough. That's a good play from the quarterback. And just that little thing making a difference, because then you're throwing it up there, and it's a jump ball, and Asante's going to win that battle.
Well, he certainly won that one, no question about it. Hey. You know, run a little football, throw a little football. Just 3 of 5 coming in that possession, okay. Dagenhart with a couple of big connections on the drive.
Holy Cross will kick it deep to Gruber. Gruber has a seam up the middle and he gets pounded at the 27-yard line.
Reynolds is just going after people.
That was a good stick.
Reynolds is the guy who had the hit on Gill earlier, and he just put the shoulder pad into Gruber there. And Gruber, a good little return, but pays for it at the end. Watch this. Here's Reynolds. Hey, yeah. I'm a DB, but I don't mind getting into it. Cornerbacks can hit too.
That's good stuff. Alex Johnson as well in there. The first guy who got him around the legs. 4 minutes to play in the first half. 14-3, Holy Cross in front of Colgate. A Patriot League game for the Crusaders. Brenneman has to run, picking his way forward and picks up 3. Great job by Holy Cross to just put him in a cage there, not allow him to get outside.
Yeah, and Liam Anderson looked like he had the assignment of watching the quarterback and spying him a little bit. And so when Brenneman broke the pocket, he looked right up and there was 29 right there. Eyeing them up, not letting them get very far.
You know, they're young, but there's a lot of depth on this defense. Now, it's depth with young guys, as freshmen and sophomores, a lot of them, but look at the defensive line and look at the linebackers you're calling, Anderson and Dobbs and Doran. And that's going to be a first down. Gill got to the stakes again, the sticks, and got forward for the first down.
Yeah, you see, you're thinking about the tailgate, stakes. You know, you only had like six or seven donuts in the pregame.
Got my limit.
So you're hungry. But, yeah, that's a nice – you know, Gill's been a pretty good weapon. Gill and the tight end, Kane, have been the two guys here.
And you can only imagine that Gill, being from Massachusetts, probably has more people at this game than any other game during the year for him. Colgate's a long ride. Brenneman bursts into the secondary. And Brenneman's across midfield into Holy Cross territory, down on the 37. The Crusaders answer, and Holy Cross sends in some fresh defensive linemen, including – Bucciarone.
Now, Brenneman can do it with his legs, and he just, good vision upfield, picking some seams. He was hobbled a little bit earlier. It looked like he ran pretty well there, though.
Yeah, he did. Maybe he's got the Jim Brown limp. Brenneman from the shotgun.
Talking about that long ride. John Grady and I made that ride out to Hamilton last year. It's a gorgeous day in New York for football that day.
Brenneman. Kiesling almost got him. Brenneman gets free and picks up eight. That's a good run for Brenneman after he almost got caught by the freshman.
And Noah Johnson's the one who ran him down, the junior out of Savannah, Georgia. Another defensive lineman. Clock running at 1:45.
Colgate has all three timeouts remaining. Brenneman has his team up line of scrimmage at the 32 of Holy Cross. They need to get to the 27 of the Crusaders for a first down. But a lot of time running off this clock right now. Colgate really taking a lot of time. The play clock down to 2 seconds when they snapped it. Brenneman fires the out pass. It's incomplete. Good defense. Kiesling saying that he tipped it too. The freshman Kiesling got a paw up there.
And good coverage to the outside from Smith. Tough guy to go after. He's been pretty good out there in coverage.
Holy Cross running some fresh defensive linemen into the ball game. Minute 19 to play in the first half. Colgate again with all three timeouts, and they face a third and five right now.
Whitley, top of your screen.
Crusaders going to rush four.
Here he comes.
Brenneman under pressure, and he's drilled. And Holy Cross is going to say that's either grounding or a fumble.
They have not made a signal yet.
Let's see. One official saying Holy Cross is football. One official pointing in the direction of Holy Cross.
The ruling on the field is an incomplete forward pass.
It was Mark Ebo who hit him, one of the leaders on this team.
Really on the field's an incomplete pass. It came in, the referee came in and made the call. They have to go out and get Whitley. Yeah, I think you're going to say his arm's going forward there.
Forward. Ebo drilled him. That's a great play.
Eyes got big there. Ebo was coming. So Ebo takes up a guy on the outside. Whitley stunts in behind him. And then Whitley, they have to go get him. Ebo comes free. They're coming after him. And they're coming after him with just four guys, which is big right now for Holy Cross. College football here on Charter TV3 brought to you by the following. Proterra Nissan of Auburn. The Bancroft School in Worcester. Milford Federal. Holy Cross Athletics. The Sullivan Group. Pucci's Fine Jewelry. Nichols College. The Wealth Management Group of Raymond James in Worcester. And the Central Mass Safety Council. Here's fourth down.
There you go, big play right here. Fourth and five for Colgate. 1:10 to play in the first half.
Timeout.
Holy Cross takes the timeout. The Crusaders will call for the timeout. Grant Brenneman coming into the game, 923 yards passing, three interceptions, three touchdowns. And a big fourth down right now for both squads. If Holy Cross, if their defense can hold the fort here, They have an 11-point lead right now. Brenneman. And they will receive the opening kick to start the second half.
Brenneman's leading rusher right now. He's got 41 yards on the ground on six carries. Just 6 of 14, though, through the air with a pick.
There you go, fourth down and five. Colgate needs to get to the 27 of Holy Cross. Brenneman fires, incomplete. Behind the intended receiver, he had some heat coming. Stefanik and company were bringing it.
Stefanik with a swim on the outside. Had a guy designed out there to block. Whoop, whoop, just swims right by him. And that is going to, it's not going to get Brenneman, but Brenneman's going to have to hurry that throw a little bit. And no shot. The Holy Cross defense makes a play. Stefanik, Riley, Ebo here. The seniors on this young defense. Yes. The older guys have made some plays, as they have throughout the year, but making some plays here.
And it's a group that's got some swagger to them. Mm. This defense, Kevin Buccheroni was yelling at Bob Chesney this week during practice, "You got no juice. Look at him. He's got no juice." In his D-line, they were all woofing at the coach. And he was going back at him. And, of course, he loves it. He loves that. Play with swagger. Play with confidence. Well, this defense has that.
Got a man here.
And it's caught. A big gainer, a block downfield. Jack Jewell. Run out of bounds inside the red zone down to the 13-yard line.
Oh, man, they had dudes going downfield here. A lot of guys streaking. You had Gilliam inside of Jewell. He ran a skinny post. Jewell right down the seam. And the throws to the outside. Look at Asante. Guy who made the touchdown catch earlier got a good block to chip off the guy. Let Jewell get a few more yards. His first catch of the game, Jack Jewell.
Holy Cross has one timeout remaining. 54 seconds to play in the first half. Dagenhart with plenty of time. Now the rush comes and he's going to throw it away.
Smart play.
Well covered by Colgate.
Nobody clear downfield, and there was plenty of time for Dagenhart to go. 47 seconds in a timeout. I was thinking that, you know, there's still an opportunity to run the football here with Cozier in the backfield. Now they bring Oliver back in. Again, that luxury of being able to get the football in the third quarter, too. If you can get six here.
Look at Mountain on the near side here. There's no one in the secondary. You'd have a linebacker on Mountain.
It's a good call.
Dagenhart to the end zone for Gilliam. Incomplete.
They weren't looking back on Mountain that time. He was well covered anyway, and they had to make a special play all the way out there to hit Gilliam. Colgate's done a good job here in the red zone. This series here, last couple plays, of really bottling up the receivers.
Yeah, that time they had Abu Durami Soiree, their great cornerback who was on Mountain. Soiree's 5'10", Mountain 6'5".
Soiree's done a job, though. You know, we haven't called Tenny Oyeni's name yet. He's the most physically imposing guy that the Crusaders have as a receiver, and Soiree has been all over him.
He's a beast. But you're right, Soiree. There they go to Ayeni. Ayeni holds on, touchdown! Tenio Ayeni!
This is a great,
all the hours in the weight room,
great read.
Off.
This is a great read from the quarterback and a great call.
Wow.
We'll see it in a bit. But Durami Soiree blitzes from that position. That opens up Ayeni, who had him on him, and then the safety or the linebacker could not get over in time. Gertner, the safety, could not get over there to get Ayeni.
That's a courageous catch, though. He knew he was going to get hit. He knew he was exposed, and he held on, got hit, and plowed through. That's a guy who gained 15 pounds of muscle and went from a 40 time of 4.7 to 4.5, and that's through all hard work. And that's where you see it come to fruition on a Saturday afternoon game
All right,
time.
Here it is. This is a great look. Dagenhart's looking at him. They see the corner blitzes, and the safety can't get to Ayeni in time.
Tenio Ayeni.
See, there's Soiree coming in on the outside. That gave just enough space to Ayeni, and it was a good read by that offense to go right to him.
Think about this turn here in the final minute of play of the half. Holy Cross holds on fourth down deep in their own end. And then 30 seconds later, they score a touchdown to go up 21-3. That's a big, big turn of events. The ultimate T-Hawk, Mike Vulcano, yeah, coming through the screen.
I will say also that Tenney Oyeni, that is his, probably his second biggest touchdown catch of the calendar year. The first would have been when he won me the spring game over Brenna Wilson. Have I mentioned that already this season?
I don't know.
I don't know if I have. Todd Gilchrist and I, we went right, hey, this defense is playing great, but Todd Gilchrist and I went right through him in the spring game. Just
that
saying.
That is the third touchdown reception for Oyeni this season, but none bigger than when he was playing for you. That set the table. That set the table for the success.
I'm sure Tenio's probably thinking that right now.
He is. He's there.
You know, besides this, the spring game touchdown, this one was huge.
And he might have even said this week to the coaching staff, let's go back to what Lacombe was running in the spring.
Up. Yeah.
You know, let's go back to that.
I like that. I like that kind of thinking out of you, Kev. I will say this. I mean, Brenda talked about the white helmet. I like the white helmets.
They look sharp.
They look good.
From up here, it gives you a little bit of the BYU feel.
They
with
look
just because of the stripe and then the lettering on the side.
You know,
but they look sharp.
If they win, you'd probably see white helmets the rest of the year.
I would guess. I mean, this, you still got a lot of football to go, and Colgate's going to keep it on the ground. That's a victory right there for the Holy Cross defense. The fact that Colgate is not going to try to take a shot deep down the field, trailing now by 18 points. That's a victory for this Holy Cross defense because they don't want to turn it over.
I don't know if they're going to run another play here.
I don't think they
will.
That's
going to be it.
And remember, Holy Cross gets the kick to start the second half. They're up 21-3. They're running the ball well. They're throwing the ball deep down the field. That's a complete first half from Holy Cross.
Yeah, that's a big one. And you know what?
Look at this, too. They're letting them know about it. I like it. Corey Stefanik's down there yelling at Colgate as they're going to the locker room. You know Buccheroni's there. I see him, 55.
And Buccheroni looks like he's actually calm. He might not be doing it. He may have just gotten some other people to do it for him this time.
He normally stirs
he's
it
the
up
guy.
Pregame.
Yeah.
But he is. That's a complete first half for Holy Cross right there. Running the ball, throwing the ball, scoring. 21 points. Brenna Wilson's down on the field now with Bob Chesney.
Coach, you've talked this year about playing with conviction, playing with confidence, and on both sides of the ball, both sides are making huge plays. What do you want to see in the second half to make sure this keeps going?
Yeah, a continuation of that. The turnover down here by Pete was not great, obviously, but I think that we're putting it together on all three phases. That's only a half a football, though, so 0-0. Obviously, we have a lot of work to continue to do. I thought we threw a couple balls with some conviction, which we were hoping for. We just got to tighten up a little bit on defense. There's little things, backs out, throwbacks, things like that, that can hit you and have happen to hit us. Not big yet, but they could, so we got to tighten that up right now.
Okay, thanks to Brenna, thanks to Bob Chesney. We are at the half at Fitton Field. Holy Cross in front of Colgate, 21-3. We'll take a short break and be back with all of our halftime activities right after.
I'm District Attorney Joe Early Jr., and I'm proud to partner with Charter Communications with our pledge to help raise awareness that bullying should not be tolerated. From local school students, here's our message.
Take a stand. Lend a hand. It isn't big to make others feel small.
We need to foster safe environments for students in their schools and communities. Join the Anti-Bully Crusade. Take a stand to lend a hand. Don't be a bully.
Presented by the Law Offices of Joseph J. Coriglia.
Our founders would have never seen this coming.
Spygate?
No.
Deflategate?
No.
What then?
Benji!
Benji knocks down any obstacle that he can get his paws on and tackles every high interest rate that gets in between us and our customers, which is why he made the Bay State Savings Bank team.
You're right. They would have never seen Benji coming, but I'm sure they're glad he came.
Bay State Savings Bank. We take banking personally.
Sullivan Group is an insurance and risk management services firm based in Worcester for over 60 years.
Our company values?
Our family values.
committed to our clients and finding them the best solutions.
Committed to being independent.
Committed to our community.
We live here, we work here, we volunteer here.
The Sullivan Insurance Group.
Committed to excellence.
Hi, I'm Rich Salmon, GM of Bertera Nissan. Come join us for our 2019 clearance event.
This is the all-new 2019 redesigned Nissan Altima, now available in all-wheel drive. Here we have the 2019 Nissan Kicks. Sporty, stylish, and incredibly fun to drive.
If you work for UMass, Fallon, St. Gobain's, Wyman Gordon, or any of Worcester's largest employers, we'll take care of you with an additional discount up to $500.
Bertera Nissan, Route 20, Auburn, Massachusetts.
Kevin, meet your father.
Kevin.
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 Trusted advice for life.
Kevin, how's your mom?
Thank you. Life well planned. See what a Raymond James financial advisor can do for you.
Bison Pride is the feeling that you get when you're with all of your Nichols friends and you're rooting for your team and your school and your community.
Yes, even though we are a smaller school, you feel the big school vibe here.
Providing our customers with the highest level of quality, service, and value. Poochie's Fine Jewelry, 205 West Boylston Street in West Boylston.
Local news from Central Massachusetts for Central Massachusetts.
A new study looks at the prices of commuter rail fares in cities like Worcester. Area schools are taking extra precautions as several communities raise the EEE threat level to critical. Police say they are still receiving reports of drivers speeding in the same area of the crash.
Reporters in the field and an in-depth local forecast. Worcester News Tonight on Charter TV3.
Welcome back to the half, where Holy Cross currently leads Colgate 21-3. And I'm joined by the Holy Cross Athletic Director, Marcus Blossom. Thank you for joining us.
Thanks for having me.
So you were just hired back in the beginning of the summer. And
correct.
A few months here under your belt. How has it been so far?
It has been a lot of fun thus far. Holy Cross is a very special place with amazing students, amazing student athletes, and a very, very passionate alumni base that really wants us to be successful. So I've had a blast.
Yeah, you know, we were talking about that, the alumni base. What have they brought and how have they kind of welcomed you?
They've really welcomed me warmly. Gave me a lot of insight into what they think we should do here in the athletic department, which is great. But the main thing about it is they support us, and they support us doing it the right way. They want us to be successful, but they also want us to continue to do it while attracting high academic student athletes, student athletes of character, and student athletes that really have a focus on being better after college and really committing to a career, and whether it's professional or service or grad school. So it's been a really good support system.
Now, you've been in a lot of the colleges in the area, so you've known Holy Cross from afar.
Right.
What were your impressions of Holy Cross before you came here?
I think they met expectations. I knew, the funny thing is, the football team played at BC last year. That kind of opened my eyes a little bit. I swear it might have been 10,000 Holy Cross fans there. So I really didn't know the alumni were so passionate, and there were so many of them. Although it's only 40,000 living alums, it seems like there's 90,000 from my time here thus far. So that was probably the biggest learning piece for me, the passion of the alumni.
Oh yeah, you know, they live and bleed there. They're purple.
Right, they do.
Now, when you started, you were kind of thrown right into the fire when you had to hire a new basketball coach. What was that process like, and what has Brett Nelson also brought to the program so far?
What was the second part of it?
What has Brett Nelson brought to the...
Oh, Brett's a stud. He is a guy full of energy. He really connects with the student athletes. He's a great teammate in the athletic department. he really embodies what Holy Cross is all about as well. He's gets out in the community, he makes sure that the students on the team are doing what they're supposed to do outside of basketball. The process was very interesting. It was, at the time, it was the only Division I job open. So my phone was ringing off the hook, calls from all over the country with interest in this job. And they really were interested for some of the reasons that we just talked about. The high academic emphasis of the college, the quality of the students that are attracted to Holy Cross, and our ability to be successful. If you look at our history in men's basketball, we've had a great deal of success, and I think Brett could help re-energize the program and bring some of that success back.
Yeah, and what kind of attracted you to Holy Cross?
It was a lot of things, but primarily, if you look at some of the places I've been, they've all been, for the most part, high academic institutions. So I think if you get a chance to hold your hat on something as an athletic department, I really enjoy holding our hat on the quality of the institution. I still believe there are student athletes that are attracted to a great academic curriculum, a beautiful campus, very, very talented professors. So that was it for one. The second piece was, after understanding how passionate the alumni were, that was also exciting. I think the brand nationally is very strong, and the Patriot League is a very competitive league. The schools are similar, that's important, and I think there's a chance for us to win and win the Patriot League in a lot of our sports.
Now, you personally, you were a student athlete.
Yes.
How important is it, you know, from your background and also seeing it here, how important is it to be a student athlete? Not just an athlete, but, you know, have both sides.
Well, it's paramount. I don't think you could be successful at a place like Holy Cross just fully committing to a sport and not giving your all into your academics. So, obviously, there's not many student athletes, not just at Holy Cross, but in the Patriot League in general, that are playing in the NFL or the NBA. So we really want our student athletes to graduate with a phenomenal degree and end up really setting their lives up for success. Oftentimes people say college is their best 4 years of their life. I feel you come to Holy Cross to have a great experience so that after college is really the best years of your life. So that's important for us.
One of the things that you put into place was creating a kind of a game day atmosphere. Right. And how has that kind of taken off, and what did you want to put in place to kind of create that?
Well, game day atmosphere is important because it really gives us, the student athletes, a ton of support. We really want the stands packed, not only for the student athlete experience, but also for recruiting. When recruits come on campus, we want them to see how wonderful the place is. Not only how wonderful the college is, but embrace the city of Worcester. My short time coming back and forth to Worcester from home, it's better than I thought. That's actually one surprise. I've heard a lot about it, about how it's grown over the last few years. When I was in college in Boston almost 20 years ago, Worcester wasn't what it is now. So that's very attractive, hopefully, to student athletes in the future.
Now, I do have to ask you, because when you were announced in this position, you said that you were going to take your kids to Disney World.
Yeah, that's funny.
Did that happen?
I did.
Excellent.
It happened. It was in June, before I started on July 1. 4 to 5 days of 97 degree heat in Orlando. They had a blast. I had somewhat fun, but I'll do it again. I told them that I'll take them again if we go to the NCAA tournament in one of our sports. So hopefully that happens again. And I'll be spending a lot more money on Disney World again. So
I'm sure they're completely happy.
Right, they're all on board.
Yeah,
they're jumping down when we score a touchdown. Because they think it's something in it for them, right?
And so, speaking of that, you know, I've seen you've been highly involved in all of the sports across the board, you know, getting out and watching these games.
Yeah.
How important is that, you know, to be able to go out and support the players?
Well, you know, to be a college athletic director means you're an athletic director of all of our teams. You really want to embrace the student athlete experience in all of our sports. You want to show the student athletes and the coaches that you support them. It also gives you an opportunity to really understand some of their needs. If you're never around, you don't really know what they need and what they're experiencing. So I think it's very important to really be at a lot of activities.
And we've talked about recruiting as well. And one of the major things here at Holy Cross is the new Booth Athletic Complex. How important is it, you know, to have buildings like that and, you know, atmospheres like this to help with the recruiting?
Right. The thing that Luth provides is the ability for our student athletes to develop. The indoor practice facility gives our student athletes always a time to get in there and practice, whether it's raining or snowing, whether it's 100 degree heat outside or not. So at Holy Cross and in this league, you want to get student athletes that are really good but have room to grow. So the Luth Athletic Complex give them an opportunity to get better.
And looking ahead to the future, what are some goals that you have in place, whether it's, you know, new facilities or just things that you want to see here at Holy Cross?
Well, there's a lot of things. I can list 25 things or so.
Keep going.
But, you know, I want to, as we touched on earlier, I want to make sure the environment is a strong environment for our student athletes and for our recruits. That's very important. Overall, we want to win more. We want to be successful. When we talk about the student athlete experience, the one factor that really affects the student athlete experience is winning. So I want to bring a winning culture. We've just built the Luth Athletic Complex, as we spoke about, but I want to provide other resources and other infrastructure to help our teams be more successful.
Awesome. Well, thank you so much for joining us. It's really great to sit down with you. We'll have much more of this game after the break.
Charter TV3 and UMass Memorial Healthcare have teamed up to bring you the latest news and trends in healthcare. Health Watch, presented by UMass Memorial Healthcare, brings you the healthcare topics that are important to you. From stroke prevention to allergies, skin care to sports injury prevention, and nutrition to pregnancy, Health Watch at UMass Memorial Healthcare informs you on the issues that affect you on a daily basis. Health Watch on Charter TV3. For extended interviews with UMass Memorial Healthcare experts, log on to our website.
Milford Federal Bank has been part of our community's history, honoring local traditions, supporting local causes, and caring about local issues since 1887. While many community banks have come and gone through the years, we're still here, committed to our loyal customers and the communities we serve. We're Milford Federal Bank, your community, your bank, your choice. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
So the next step for you guys is to start taking circumferences.
See where it's marked on beats 1 and 3 in that measure? Okay, good. Let's go one more time from the beginning.
Here we go.
Yeah.
All right. Awesome.
Cross up 21-3 over Colgate at the half, and the Crusaders getting it going on the ground early. Peter Oliver capping the first drive of the game for the Holy Cross offense as they punch it in for 7.
Yeah, you know what? They did some things on the special teams as well. Bob Chessy said we got to make our money on special teams. Charles Prince with a nice down there, and then a pick the other way. Reynolds off the tip drill interception. Defense making plays, Cap.
Yeah, they were aggressive, very aggressive. And then the Colgate defense coming up with a big play there as they force the turnover. It results in a field goal for the Raiders as they get on the board. At that point, it was 14-3.
It was 7-3, actually. Crusaders come back with a Yerisante. They score 14 unanswered late in this half. Thanks to Degenhart and Asante and the defense making plays. And then this one to Tenio Ayeni late.
Just a strength move right there. Ayeni knows he's going to get hit. His ribs are exposed. Goes up, grabs it, hangs on into the end zone. 21-3, Holy Cross. And people are having career days right now. Connor Dagenhart having the best game of his career. He's 7 of 11 for 127 yards and 2 touchdowns. Dom Cozier has already rushed for over 100 yards. He's got 127 yards rushing. This is a big-time offensive output right now in show for this offense.
And you talked about how Bob Chesney challenged his offensive line this week, and the offensive line has stepped up and risen to that challenge, pushing the pile on the ground attack and giving Dagenhart, their quarterback, plenty of time to throw the football for the most part. That one turnover, notice that's the one thing that Bob Chesney mentioned, we got to clean up on the offensive side and some things on defense as well, but that, they're keenly aware of that. They want to be perfect here in the second half. Go back to last year, this game, first game of the season, it was all Colgate in the first half. The Crusaders scored 14 points late in that game, made a game of it, had a chance to win it. Bob Chesney knows that. He knows his team can't let up because Colgate can do the same thing to them here in the second half.
This is certainly the most complete first half of play for Holy Cross this season. Look at the total yards of offense. Holy Cross, 319 yards of offense in the first half and holding Colgate to 175. That's a big, big stat.
Yeah, it's a big number, and the balance in that number. You know, it's not just all passing. It's a great balance, 143 yards rushing for Holy Cross, getting it done in the red zone. And Colgate, again, the time of possession stat is always a little bit misleading. It was 2-1 after the first quarter in favor of Holy Cross. Colgate actually has the time of possession edge in the overall in the half. So, you know, and then getting off the field on third downs, 2 of 6. Okay, I think the defense will take that right now if Colgate's 2 of 6 on third down conversions. So there's Connor Dagenhart, and, you know, he's a guy that they went to right away, won the battle in preseason camp, and, you know, has kind of grown and developed in his skill here throughout the year. And sometimes he looks unbelievable, and then Bob Chesney just says we just need consistency out of him, and he's been pretty darn good today.
Yeah, Holy Cross, their offense was 5 of 7 on third down conversions in the first half. I mean, that's a big stat right there. When they need to convert, they did in the first half. And again, they will take the ball here to start the second half of play. They'll receive the opening kickoff. Miles Alexander, Spencer Gilliam back deep to receive for Holy Cross as the Crusaders go towards the closed end of the stadium with a 21-3 lead. And for my money, certainly the most complete half of football that Holy Cross has played in all three phases.
You know what? Other than the fumble, it's an almost near perfect half. No coach will ever say it's perfect, though. They'll always find something, and that's what you do.
Both sidelines are bouncing. The Holy Cross sideline trying to get this crowd going. Get them behind them. A family weekend crowd here at Fitton Field, and it's a good crowd. Lost a few of them at the half. See if they can rein them back in. Some have yet to enter the stadium, just enjoying the tailgating.
You know, it's always a great scene out there on the outfield and of the baseball field. But unless they're streaming the game on a big screen down there, I don't know if they've seen any action.
I like that idea, though.
I like that idea,
Charter, just streaming on a big screen there for the tailgaters.
We're not quite on the app yet, but it could be coming.
All right. Big things coming. Charter TV3, part of the Spectrum Sports Family Network.
That's right.
Connor Dagenhart from the shotgun to start things off. Dom Cozier is in the backfield with him. Cozier already over 100 yards rushing. Gilliam goes in motion. And it's Dagenhart. Pulls it down, keeps it, and slides down close to a first down. Great read from Connor Dagenhart.
Yeah, smart read on the RPO and you know, the quarterback option here. He can see the heat coming on the outside. His running back is going to get destroyed. So he tucks it away, and, you know, the whole defense flows that way. Our camera flowed that way, too. It's a good ball fake.
First rush of the game for Dagenhart. And again, it's not necessarily, you don't have to be a burner, and you don't have to pick up 40 yards, but he got 8, and he keeps him honest. And Cozier has a first down for Holy Cross as he gets out to the 39-yard line.
And it's runs like that and the ones that we saw in the first half that forced the defense to respect a handoff to Cozier, and which freed up Dagenhart on the last play. There's a Raider down in the secondary. So there'll be a stoppage on the field.
Dom Cozier averaged over 10.5 yards a carry in the first half. and he just got six on that run. We'll take a timeout from Fitton Field. Opening minute here of the second half, 21-3 Holy Cross.
Sullivan Group is an insurance and risk management services firm based in Worcester for over 60 years.
With the tremendous growth of life sciences both globally and locally, we've dedicated our resources to build a strong, knowledgeable, and responsive team to meet the insurance and risk management needs of this dynamic industry.
Our personal lines team will make sure your home, your car, your personal belongings, and most importantly, your family are protected.
The Sullivan Group has the resources, the carriers, and the coverage to protect you and your business.
Hi, I'm Rich Salmon, GM of Bertera Nissan. Come join us for our 2019 clearance event.
This is the all-new 2019 redesigned Nissan Altima, now available in all-wheel drive. Here we have the 2019 Nissan Kicks. Sporty, stylish, and incredibly fun to drive.
If you work for UMass, Fallon, St. Gobain's, Wyman Gordon, or any of Worcester's largest employers, we'll take care of you with an additional discount up to $500.
Bertera Nissan, Route 20, Auburn, Massachusetts.
Welcome back, everyone. You get a look at that Holy Cross offensive group huddled up as they discuss what they'll try to do when we come out of the timeout. A very clean first half, Andy. Only three penalties, one on Colgate, two on Holy Cross in the first half. So both squads very clean.
Yeah, and we talked about balance in terms of, you know, offensively running the football and passing the football, and the numbers kind of very similar, almost 50-50, a little edge to the passing game, but different guys contributing. The Irsante was the hot hand for a little while. Jack Jewell makes that big 55-yard catch to set up a touchdown, and then Ieni with the touchdown. So Degenhardt's been able to spread it out. He's hit five different receivers, including Cozier on the backfield. Has some options here.
Degenhardt from the shotgun. He's got Dom Cozier with him. Now they change the play. Three wide receivers to the top of the screen. Mountain, the tight end, to the bottom of the screen. Mountain on man coverage. Degenhardt has time, goes deep, and the receiver never saw it. Gilliam was looking inside. The pass was outside.
I think you and I are both kind of rooting for him to go to Mountain, aren't we? I mean, it's Mountain, but Mountain has the guy.
He
has the guy on
him,
Abu Dharami Soare. And that tells you just what Colgate thinks of Derek Mountain when they put their lockdown guy on the tight end, almost as like a safety, like a linebacker covering him. Right now, he's out, is Soare, he's out on Asante here on the bottom of your screen.
Mountain goes in motion, comes back on a power play, and Mountain with a kickout block. Cozier gets close to a first down.
He had a good block there, did Mountain, no question about it. And that offensive line flowing behind him. Brett Boddy, one of those guys, wicked block from Durrell up the middle too. He took up some space in the middle. I like the way this line is playing.
Bob Chesney said Derek Mountain's blocking improves every single day in practice. He's gotten so much better as a blocker, and they liked him as part of this power wham series. Cozier's second effort, and he's going to come up short of the first down. I thought initially he actually had more forward progress than even on the second.
Yeah.
He wants to go for it.
He wants to go.
He's saying, give me the ball again and let's go.
But they're going to bring the punter out. They're going to bring Ng out here to punt. Here. Good job by that Colgate defense. They put a plug in that hole quickly.
Soare is back deep to receive. He is a dangerous return man. And Holy Cross has a lot of respect for him. Let's see if they will probably have Ng just try to hang it real high. Ng kicks it, and Soare makes the grab. He called for the fair catch, makes the catch at about the 22-yard line.
Really good play by the kick returner, the punt returner there, because that takes a Holy Cross bounce. It could be down inside the 10-5-yard line. So he comes up and saves them some serious field position.
And if you're Colgate, you like what just happened.
Yeah, that's exactly what you had to have.
The defense forcing the punt.
It's exactly what you had to have. A quick possession by the Crusaders. You get the ball back and have a chance to start plugging away and chipping away at this lead.
Brenneman, quarterback, the preseason player of the year, an all-league performer a year ago. Diaco, the tight end, gets the call. Diaco does a lot for this offense, whether he's running the ball, taking a direct snap, or from his tight end position.
What do you call that, Kevin? Is that a tight end sweep? And, you know, this is the tight end run, and Dobbs comes away with the tackle. Whitley makes it happen because Whitley held his guy up and did not allow the tight end, Diaco, to get any north-south progression, or a lot of it anyway. Picked up a few.
And Brenneman looks over at the sideline. Brenneman calling signals. We're 3 minutes into the second half of play. Holy Cross backing off a little bit. Brenneman design roll to his right. Dobbs is coming. He hits his man for a first down. Riley knocks him out of bounds. Nick Drought.
Nice job here on the edge. You see the block there from the H-back there to really take out the defensive end. Open up the throwing lane for Brenneman.
Yeah, it's a good read. Zone coverage, and you just run a sprint flood route. And you got two receivers, one down low and one over the top. So Brenneman's got him moving now. Colgate at their own 48-yard line. And they hand it off on first down. And a gain of three. Some tough sledding up front. Mark Ebo, one of the men in there on the stop for Holy Cross.
Yeah, Matthews is going to end up getting five, just kind of riding the wave behind his line. You know, they've moved the ball. Obviously, they've got some yards here in between the 20s, in between the 30s. Holy Cross has really tightened up when Colgate's gotten into their side of the field.
Holy Cross showing blitz. Now they back off. Here they come. Brenneman gets it away, and it's broken up. Beautiful defense on the far side from John Smith.
Yeah, John Smith is on lockdown mode right now. Good position. Got his body turned around at the right time and knocked that one away. It's one-on-one out here. It's on the island. Good physical defense. See, the Gill wanted to see if he could position him a little bit, but nice play by Smith.
Third down and five. Colgate needs to get to the Holy Cross 42. And then they move, so it's going to be now a third and 10. Great job, Stefanik. I think drew him off sides.
Number 64, 5 yard penalty, third down.
Yeah, that's one of those things where Stefanik moved first, but it was almost maybe about the same time as the tackle backing up.
That's a big 5 yard penalty right there. Now you got third and 10. Stefanik at the top of the screen.
Working this play clock down under five.
Brenneman hands it off, and the Holy Cross defense drops it for a loss.
Ebo leading the way. Sedano as well.
That is well played.
Ebo was looking like he wanted to jump this thing earlier, and watch him just get in there and two defensive tackles in the backfield. They had 14 tackles for loss last week against Harvard, which is like, seems like that's like 2 or 3 weeks worth of TFLs. And they get one here in a big way.
Most in over a decade for our Holy Cross team. Colgate, booming punt. Hits at the four and takes a hop into the end zone. Holy Cross will come out to the 20. 9:48 remaining here in the third quarter. The Crusaders will have the ball when we return.
Kevin, meet your father.
Kevin.
Kevin.
Kevin. Kevin.
Kevin.
Kevin.
Kevin.
Kevin.
Trusted advice for life.
Kevin, how's your mom?
Thank you.
Life well planned. See what a Raymond James financial advisor can do for you.
Bison Pride is the feeling that you get when you're with all of your Nichols friends and you're rooting for your team and your school and your community.
Yes, even though we are a smaller school, you feel the big school vibe here.
providing our customers with the highest level of quality, service, and value. Pucci's Fine Jewelry, 205 West Boylston Street in West Boylston.
There's the Holy Cross offense. Now they're averaging 302 yards of total offense a game. In the first half alone, they had 319 yards of total offense. So they eclipsed their season average for a whole game in one half of football. But as the coach has said, you know, they're stressing to them, there's a lot of football left, and we cannot take our foot off the gas.
Yeah, they only average 18 points a game scoring the football, and they're above that as well. So still a long way to go, and this offense has some work to do.
Cozier's in the backfield with Connor Dagenhart. Two wide receivers, a power formation for Holy Cross, and they run the power play. And Cozier breaks it out to the outside, spins through a tackle, gets out over the 30, first down for Holy Cross, and a 10-yard pickup for Cozier.
Yeah, he's running next level right now. I mean, this is as good as we've seen Cozier run the ball. Looks where he has the space, bounces to the outside, and then not first contact, spins and gets another 4 or 5 yards. He's really moving the football right now. And his offensive line's doing a great job. Cozier is everything that he's billed to be. He's making it, he's backing it up today.
Peter Oliver in the backfield. Two tight end set, power set. Oliver first down and more. And Oliver was hit at the 40 and gets forward to the 42-yard line. Another pickup of 10 or more for Holy Cross on the ground.
They've got this power football schemed up so well, and Jack Bowler is having a day. 68, middle of your screen, gets the linebacker, frees the hole, good block from Foley, driving his guy back, and Oliver with a big pickup.
Oliver remains in the game. Another two tight end formation for Holy Cross. Dagenhart to throw, taking a shot downfield, has a man, Ianni.
Yeah.
He was tangled up on the far side. Looked like there was a little hand fighting going on.
Yeah, it was pretty, you know, might have been a little bit. It looked like Ianni kind of came inside towards the hash marks a little too much, and that slowed him up. I think it was a pretty good ball from Dagenhart, one-on-one, like that matchup.
Second down and 10 for Holy Cross. Oliver in the game. Mountain is the tight end. Three wide receiver set. Dagenhart looks for the quick hitter. It's caught. Asante, first down and more.
He's gone.
Asante with a seam. Foot race to the end zone. Ayer Asante, the freshman, goes the distance. 58 yards on the touchdown strike from Dagenhart to Asante. This offense is in high gear.
Wow. Wow, Kev. You know, they've been throwing the ball on the perimeter, on the edges, and they've been going downfield. This time they try to work the middle, and it works. And they get some blocks after the catch to spring Asante. And Brenna gave us a report last week, and we've talked about it. This is a guy in Asante who they clock and they measure at full speed, and he's their receiver in practices who gets the full speed the fastest and stays at full speed the longest. And he just showed us his speed there.
Ayer Asante with his second touchdown reception of the day. Holy Cross, 28-3 over Colgate.
Milford Federal Bank has been part of our community's history, honoring local traditions, supporting local causes, and caring about local issues since 1887. While many community banks have come and gone through the years, we're still here, committed to our loyal customers and the communities we serve. We're Milford Federal Bank, your community, your bank, your choice. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
So the next step for you guys is to start taking circumferences.
See where it's marked on beats 1 and 3 in that measure?
Okay, good.
Let's go one more time from the beginning.
Here we go.
Yeah.
All right.
All right, here's the touchdown. And it's Dagenhart going inside. Peter Oliver picks up the blitzing linebacker. They go back through. And the block from Mountain Springs, Asante. Man, he looks fast. He's even faster in person. Here's Mountain. He's just going to trail, and he's going to take away a couple of guys. And then, man, Asante, there's not many guys that are going to catch him. He just runs away from the defense. But again, they were looking outside, outside, outside. Now they come back inside. There was just one safety in the middle of the field, and they're able to come back through with a year of Asante.
It's a great call by the offensive coordinator, Pat Murphy. And they've been going deep. So many times they've been going deep, deep, deep. So now they catch Colgate thinking deep and getting deep, kind of a shell coverage. You get some space underneath, and this is what Asante can do.
And, you know, he had a guy on his back shoulder, and it was a good ball by Dagenhart to get it to his guy. But once he beat his guy, there was room to run. Ayer Asante, four catches, 144 yards, and two touchdowns right now.
And they're kicking to Gruber. Gruber calls a fair catch at the two.
Well, he'll get it out at the 25.
That's right. You get it at the 25.
But
it's
that's almost like, that's all right. We're not really having a lot of success returning the football, so let's be safe and get decent field position.
Make a sure-handed play. Milbury putting the wood to Oxford. Worcester Tech over Holy Name. That would be a big one.
That's an eye-opener.
For the Eagles. Wow. St. Bernard's. And Blackstone Millville going over the century mark. Is that a final, Georgetown and Lehigh?
Not yet.
16-10 right now. Georgetown in front of Lehigh. Lehigh's 2-0 in league play. Georgetown 1-1 in league play. Holy Cross plays Lehigh next week.
Who coaches Lehigh?
Tom Gilmore, former Holy Cross coach.
That's good for him.
They are doing well over there. There's Liam Doran with the tackle for Holy Cross.
They got some dudes down.
Yeah, in his first year as the head coach of Lehigh, and they've opened some eyes with a couple wins. They beat Fordham in overtime. They beat Colgate in a game where they stopped Colgate on the last play of the game at the one-yard line. Incredible. And then last week they win in overtime, so they've...
And Lehigh just took the lead in that game. They just took the lead, 17-16 now.
That would set up a huge game next week. If Lehigh holds on and wins, and Holy Cross wins...
Do you think, there's an incomplete pass, do you think Coach Gilmore, if Sean, you and I drove down there, he'd have us over to the house?
I don't think he'll go home this week. If they win, I think he'll sleep at work.
We'd have to go find him at somewhere in Bethlehem.
I think he would work 22 out of 24 hours a day for this week. We'd have to just bring pizza to the office.
Yeah. He liked it when you brought up Dairy Queen.
That's right. Here's Brenneman, 7:44 to play in the third quarter. Brenneman with a two running back set. Brenneman sacked.
Anderson
got him. And this offense right now, or the defense rather, playing with swagger, playing with confidence, and they're going for the throat, baby.
Man, we haven't seen this in some time. I tell you, this is fun watching this defense work. They're swimming. I mean, he's like doing the butterfly, getting through people, and wow.
Anderson. Former high school quarterback swimming an offensive guard to get to the quarterback and get a sack.
If you're just joining us, it hasn't always been this way.
No, not in the least. I was thinking that, it's funny you say that. Here's Roberts. Robert's still on his feet, and he's thrown down at the 46. But I was thinking that when we went to break it after the last Holy Cross touchdown, and you and I and Sean Grady can certainly remember, and Dave Bolduc on our crew, so many games throughout the years where the second half was Colgate's half in this stadium here at Fitton Field, and so many games where it was Colgate. You know, you'd flip the script here, and it was Colgate up 28-3 in the second half and just pounding the rock.
Well, Kev, it was 45-7 2 years ago, something like that. It was the largest margin of victory ever in this 82 years of this matchup. Colgate came in to Fitton 2 years ago and pumped Holy Cross 45-7. It was the biggest margin of victory they ever had over Holy Cross in all those years.
Seven in a row in this series. Two back set now, Miles Alexander, but the whistle blows before it starts.
Timeout was taken by Holy Cross. But in that 45-7 game, Darmkozer's a sophomore, so Mark Evo's a sophomore. A lot of these guys that, you know, they remember what happened. Yeah. And they remember what happened last year. There's no question about it. These are young guys. Last year was a great game in Hamilton, New York. Crusaders came all the way back and nearly had it. And you never know what happens after a game like that. Colgate goes on to win the league and move on to postseason. College football on Charter TV3, presented by the law offices of Joseph J. Cariglia and by Bay State Savings Bank. But, I mean, in terms of the offensive line play, it's been the best I've seen all year.
They are playing. They are just paving the way right now. Now Holy Cross goes back to a one-back set. Wouldn't be surprised, though, to see some two-back sets here, especially in the second half. And just power it. The tight end goes the kick-out block. You're just running some power right now.
Yeah, nice play. Coleman Coco. Brosh and company, but, man, good flow there from the Colgate defensive line.
Cole Pirowitz is in there as the second tight end. So Holy Cross going with two tight ends. Pirowitz in Mountain. Double tight end set. This is power football. Dagenhart rolls to his right and completes it to Gilliam. Gilliam just ran out of real estate. It was a great catch by Gilliam. If he had about another yard or two before the sideline, he would have been able to turn that up.
Yeah, and that's the only reason this doesn't go for more. And now this is Dagenhart just kind of missing, just throwing a little too far out for Gilliam that he has to make that play to and just get out of bounds. But, you know, they roll Dagenhart out a lot. He throws a lot on the run. They design a lot of plays like that. But his line has really protected him. A lot of times they design that when he's been under siege all day and he's rolling out away from the pressure.
A lot of guys in the box here. At the snap, here's Gilliam underneath. Gilliam's got a first down, still on his feet. Wow, Gilliam ran through two tackles. He gets down to the 40 of Colgate, but Gilliam, had there not been that third defender right there.
Might have spun away for six. You're right, good protection. And watch Gilliam. This is what they love about their guys, right? This is why they do all that work. You know, you don't just get spun down. You got the first down. You continue to try to make a play, make the effort. Gilliam's getting things done.
Colgate took a timeout. 28-3 Holy Cross. 5:34 to play here in the third quarter at Fitton Field. And this offense for Holy Cross is cranking up right now. And don't think that this offensive line doesn't love running some of this power football too and love the two tight end sets. And say, let's go. Let's go straight at them.
You know, Ayer Sante's made some plays, big plays in this game, a couple of touchdown catches, but they've gone to Gilliam a couple of times now on third down where they needed to get the first down. They've dragged him across the middle of the field like they did there, and they did it earlier in the first half. He's made two big catches to get Holy Cross first downs and keep their drives moving.
Here's a two running back set. Bob Chesney said, we need Gilliam to be the man in this game. He said it of Asante, Gilliam, and Ayeni. We need them to be the man. First down run. Picks up a yard.
Down. So here's going a little tempo here, right back on the line of scrimmage.
Here's Pete Oliver. Oliver breaks a tackle, stiff arms a man, first down and more. Pete Oliver inside the 25, down to the 24-yard line.
Well, and that's the difference, right? I mean, you know, before they were telling him, hey, listen, you're only going a half a yard after first contact. There's contact, and he keeps going, trucking another 10 yards and another first down. Oh, they're in trouble here, though.
Yep.
They tried to sprint out with Alexander, and he got knocked down in the backfield.
And that one goes for a loss of 5 on the play. It'll bring up 2nd and 15.
Now you can see why Nick Iannelli is all over the football field. And you can see why he's the leading tackler in the league and on this team.
Connor Kennedy, John Roberts, Jack Jewell, 3 new receivers in the ballgame for Holy Cross. Oliver in the backfield. Dagenhart rolls to his left. Dagenhart's going to tuck it and run. Dagenhart picks up 7 yards, and it'll bring up second or third down and 8. Took a good shot to Degenhart as he went to the turf, and a whole great Colgate defensive lineman is down, maybe a cramp issue.
Yeah, that's what it looks like.
Can't roar.
You hope for Colgate, so he's not seriously injured. Degenhart has the option on the outside, it looks like, here to try to see if John Roberts can get free. And when Roberts didn't get free fast enough, that's when Degenhart had to tuck it and run. Yeah, hopefully get this guy right up. He'll be okay.
Cam Rohr, 6'2", 315.
Yeah, he's a big
guy. That's a big dude.
This is, you know, we got a gorgeous day. It's not super warm, but it's in the high 50s and beautiful sunshine. We've been lucky. We've been blessed here this fall so far, especially in our college games where we're getting great weather. It's not always like this, you know, later in the year, as we get later in the year. It can be a bit chilly up here in the non-heated press box.
The old tool shed.
The old shed. Just up here.
Some plywood. Let's see, now the Holy Cross is getting a substitution penalty.
Yeah, they had an extra lineman on the field.
That'll be 5 yards.
There is no foul for substitution infraction. The player started running off the field prior to the ready for play. Third down.
They do not, they picked the flag up.
All right. So now that run, though, makes this a little more manageable and may put them in four down territory, too, where they are right now at the 24-yard line. Third down and 9. Connor Degenhart from the shotgun with Pete Oliver back there. Holy Cross needs to get inside the 15. 3 wide receivers to the near side. Degenhart looking right the whole way. Now he's going to take off and run. Degenhart's got some room. He slides down and hits.
That should be a flag.
Yeah, helmet to helmet. Degenhart may be out. No, he's back. He pops up, but he got a shot head to head. He picked up the first down, but that may be a targeting.
They
as
may
you
have,
mentioned, and
they
that
may have
be
to look
game
at
set
him.
Match there.
Yeah, they may have to look at Degenhart. He was sliding, and the hit was up.
Defense, number 35. Half the distance to the goal.
So it's
first
just
down.
A personal foul call. It's not a targeting call. Let's see. Yeah, you just saw the head snap back, but he didn't come at him and lead with him. And anyway, he does throw that forearm shiver out, but the helmet was on the ball. So Degenhart will
be a big loss for Colgate, Iannelli, because he'd be out for the next game too.
Yeah, Degenhart will be okay. Showing a little toughness there, the QB. I don't know if he still has the mustache. I didn't get a good look at him. Brenna's gonna have to see. Just getting his face on the bench. But like these QBs with the mustaches, I don't know, you know, I know some guys, you got a mustache, you gotta be tough.
Yeah, that's true. Degenhart's dad played football here at Holy Cross, was a tight end. Oliver is stacked up and driven backwards. At the 5 is where they'll score his progress. So it's second down and goal, Holy Cross from the Colgate 5. 3:05 and counting here in the third quarter. Preseason favorite to win the Patriot League, these Colgate Raiders. Good battle going on. Pirowitz throwing one of the Colgate Raiders to the turf.
Yeah, Iannelli's been kind of mixing it up with body as well. There's been some good little, I'll tell you what, it's been a good little healthy animosity out there. 28-3, 2.5 minutes left, third quarter, still a lot of time. There's going to be a timeout here on the field as there's a
Jack Bowler,
who's had a
starting right
game.
Guard, is down right now.
He's had a monster game for them. But, you know, if you look at 28-3, and Bob Chesney told his guys this week, no scoreboard watching, we don't care what's going on elsewhere, we don't care what the score was of the Bucknell versus Colgate game or, you know, what happened earlier in their year. But if you're around the league and you're looking at 28-3, Colgate might be 1-7, but they're still Colgate. And you see Holy Cross 28-3. They might not be surprised if Holy Cross is leading, but 28-3 has turned some heads.
Yeah, dominating. Here's Anthony Cerundolo, the head athletic trainer, does a great job here walking with Jack Polaroff. And don't think that this offensive line isn't going to be ticked off, too, when they see one of their guys go down. Close, close group to the end zone. Mountain broken up. Excellent defense.
Yeah,
Colgate knocking it down. Colin Hurd.
Great play because Mountain's a big guy, and you got to get it up high to him, and Hurd makes a play. It's a pretty good ball. Mountain just can't hang on. Hurd makes a great play in there. It comes in to try to extend the lead.
20-yard field goal attempt for Derek Ng. A 28-3 Holy Cross lead. And Ng puts it up and through. And Holy Cross ends the drive with 3 points and a 31-3 lead for the Crusaders with 2 minutes and 15 seconds still to play in the third quarter.
Yeah, that's a big one. Derek Ng, he's been solid this year. Missed one last week against Harvard. That was a deep ball into the wind, 49 yards. His only other miss was his first ever attempt this season against Navy. He's made all the rest.
Had a big one against Syracuse, what, a 47-yarder against Syracuse in the dome?
He's got a leg. He's hit as long as 48 this year. And you know, had the leg to make that one against Harvard last week, but missed it just wide. But he's been really, really solid. And he's he's a kicker, but he's contributing on the punting game. But he also gets fired up down there. You see, throws the hands up. He's a big time weapon for them.
Gruber and Soiree back deep to receive for Colgate. They are looking into the sun. Gruber to the 15.
Gruber be a hold there.
Gets to the outside, cuts it back up. Gruber gets drilled at the 30-yard line. Oh, Holy Cross says they got the football, but the officials are going to say no, he was down.
Get it at the 30-yard line. One of the Crusaders in the middle of the field got dragged to the ground. I thought they were going to get a call there.
.204 to play in the third quarter. The Raiders offense comes back out onto the field.
Bump it down.
I'll tell you, this is incredible what's being done today. As we talked about, even Colgate's record, okay, they're 1-7, but still, this is a team that was ranked in the top 10 of the country last year, went deep into the playoffs, led the country in total defense. They didn't graduate that much. They graduated some starters from that team, but not. You have the returning defensive player of the year. You got the returning preseason player of the year in all leaguers, 10 preseason all-league picks, most of any team in the conference.
And, and again, that's all preseason stuff. You got injuries happen, and guys aren't 100%, and things go against you. But, they still are loaded over there. Holy Cross is doing some things here in this game.
It's incredible. Brenneman with time fires to the far sideline, and it's complete.
Yep.
Oh, now they're going to throw it down. I think that was more of an act than anything. It was a continuation. I think that one's somewhat of a scoreboard play right there, too. That's exactly what Smith's saying. Smith's saying he was doing the cartoon.
It's number 27.
Yeah.
15-yard penalty. First down.
Flinging him. I don't know if you get another look at it. Here's the look. This is, he just gets him out of bounds, and then...
See, he's not throwing them there. He's.
Yeah. It's pretty good. Pretty good.
He didn't even throw him. He just. Whatever.
Just kind of tripped.
Is what it is. It's 31-3, and that's why you're going to get that call.
It's a good one.
Here's Brenneman now inside of Holy Cross territory. Brenneman has time. Whitley was coming.
Oh, and it's Riley!
Picked off by Riley.
Oh, my goodness.
Riley. He has been all over the field this year. And Riley coming up with another big one. His third interception of the season.
He's playing in his own video game right now. That was nuts. Look at this. He just tips it up to himself.
That is incredible.
He's having himself a day. He's having himself a season for sure, but wow. Goodness gracious. Hey, it's good to be healthy, right?
First time ever that his shoulder's been healthy coming into the season.
Good to be healthy.
He has battled shoulder injuries since he was in high school and surgeries, and the healthiest he's been. There's Scott James, the defensive coordinator, giving him a hug. First down, Degenhart pulls it, fires to Gilliam on the far side. Well designed, well executed.
Uh-oh.
Ball is loose, but they're saying he's down. They're saying he's down. It's a 19-yard pickup on first down.
Right at the 35-yard line. We'll get a look at it. We'll look at it from down in the end zone. See where he is. Oh yeah, that looked like he was down. They're gonna review it. They're gonna review it, but tough to tell if the ball was coming loose when he was down there, but certainly it jarred loose when his elbow hit the ground. This might be tough to overturn.
Yeah, they'll look at it.
The life of the review here. Let's get another look. This is from up top. Well, it's tough to tell. How about the spin of the ball? I mean, it's sitting there on the sideline. It's not even moving.
Looks like one of your wedge shots, just sitting on the dance floor.
Tough to tell if he had full possession there, but when he hits the ground, the ball comes loose. So.
Yeah, his shoulder, his
elbow, and they're not,
forearm,
again, Patriot League isn't using our cameras. They've got, like, these other security camera type things up all over the stadium. So we'll see what they look at. Ruling the field is confirmed. So Ole Cross keeps the football. So the Crusaders get a good gainer on their first play here. We'll sprint out to Gilliam.
19-yard pickup.
Gilliam's off the field, though, now. I don't know if he's there, but they just put up the injury tent here on the near side.
He did go down hard. He went down hard head first. Holy Cross needs him. Here's Cozier. Cozier gets to the outside, and a lot of white jerseys there to meet him.
This is a great job from Aiden Gertner. He helps kind of string this play out.
That's the last play of the third quarter. Dom Cozier wants this game to keep going. He wants them to keep feeding him. There's Chris Smith, happy with the way his O-line has been doing here and paving the way. Crusaders up 31-3 after three quarters. The fourth quarter's coming up next.
I'm District Attorney Joe Early Jr., and I'm proud to partner with Charter Communications with our pledge to help raise awareness that bullying should not be tolerated. From local school students, here's our message.
Step up so others won't get stepped on. Take a stand and lend a hand.
We need to foster safe environments for students in their schools and communities. Join the Anti-Bully Crusade. Take a stand to lend a hand. Don't be a bully.
Presented by the Law Offices of Joseph J. Coriglia.
Our founders would have never seen this coming.
Spygate?
No.
Deflategate?
No.
What then?
Benji! Benji knocks down any obstacle that he can get his paws on and tackles every high interest rate that gets in between us and our customers, which is why he made the Bay State Savings Bank team.
You're right. They would have never seen Benji coming, but I'm sure they're glad he came.
Bay State Savings Bank. We take banking personally.
All right, Holy Cross making plays defensively, and Chris Riley tips that one to his teammate Reynolds for a pick. And then Yeah, there's the same one. And then Riley will just tip one to himself. Why not? Hey, give him an assist on one and his own on the next. He's been active. Really finds the football. And the Crusaders winning on the turnover battle and winning on the scoreboard.
We get set to start the fourth quarter of play. Kevin Shea with Andy Lacombe and Brenna Wilson, our entire Charter TV3 production crew. Live from Fitton Field, Holy Cross in front of Colgate, 31-3. Dagan Hart to throw off of play action, looking deep. Fires, he's got Asante. Ayer Asante out of bounds, and they say incomplete. He was juggling the ball. Would have been another big, big play for the Crusader freshman.
Yeah, they had a lot of guys on that sideline, and they just had Jack Jewell here in one-on-one coverage. So it might be something they look at with that look next time. They've got a lot of bodies coming in and out here.
Third down,
five receiver
for Holy Cross.
They're empty.
Crusaders 7 of 11 on third downs this game. Here comes the rush. Dagan Hart gets it off. It's deflected, and a flag comes down. That was great defense there by Durami Soiree.
Pass interference.
Ooh. That's a big call.
Too good defensively.
Let's see.
Officials have really talked over a lot of things here.
For offensive pass interference, the ball was touched behind the line of scrimmage. Fourth down.
No flag. They pick up another flag. This group's picked up a bunch of flags today. They've talked it out. It's probably the right call.
That one, I think they said because the ball was behind
the line of scrimmage.
Behind the line
of scrimmage, yeah. So they've done well. Let's give credit to our referee, William Boyd, today.
Billy.
I don't know if he goes by Billy, but William Boyd's doing a nice job out there.
Billy the Kid. This could be Wilkinson. Cody Wilkinson now punting for Holy Cross. It is Wilkinson.
It's a good one.
High hanging, booming punt. Wow. Fair catch at the 17-yard line. That's a great job by Wilkinson.
And who's the guy down there? It's Prince again. And that Prince is coming down on top of Durami Soiree, and that's the reason you have to call fair catch, because you've got a guy who can get downfield like Terrell Prince. Small things that don't show up in the stat sheet, but a great punt from Wilkinson and good coverage downfield.
It's a big play, another big play of the special teams, and again, it speaks to the depth that is building here at Holy Cross. Brenneman, the quarterback. Brenneman to throw. Here comes the rush. He gets it off, takes a hit. And it's a 3-yard pickup for Colgate.
Tell you, Liam Doran tracking in the middle of the field is the one who makes that tackle. Doran, we talked about him earlier in the year. He came in from St. John's. They tried to make him a D lineman because they had so many linebackers last year. And this year they needed him back at linebacker, so he cut weight, got faster. He's been a big part of that interior linebacking core.
One of the best in the state as a senior at St. John's High School in Shrewsbury. And how about the run defense? There's Dobbs, the freshman. Kiesling, the freshman.
Yeah, and that's the thing. I mean, this is a young defense for the most part. Riley and Stefanik and Evo, we talked about them and how good they've been today and throughout the year. But around them, there's a lot of youth and a lot of future.
Remember, too, this is a defense that lost Joe Lang, their second leading tackler, early in the game. He hasn't returned. Brenneman to throw. Here comes the rush. Brenneman gets it off, and it's caught by the tight end. Nice grab by Diaco.
What a great catch. He does have to make a full-on adjustment here to make this play. There's heat coming from Prince. And they didn't quite account for Diaco got inside.
West Deptford, New Jersey, the senior Diaco, 6'4", 230.
They got a great Wawa down there.
Brenneman underneath, incomplete. He was looking for Diaco again. 12:45 to play in the ball game, 31-3. Holy Cross in front. Crusaders looking to go 2-0 in Patriot League play.
Lehigh won that game over Georgetown by a field goal.
That's final huge.
Would set up a big matchup next week in Bethlehem, Pennsylvania, if this score stays true.
It would be the only two undefeated teams in league play. Brenneman underneath, and a great job by Smith, making the tackle short of a first down. Defense is flying.
Have you ever been to a Wawa?
I must have, because they're just driving down to
West Deptford. I was there for a Little League tournament years ago. Nice country down there. You know what? Smith's having a day. Reynolds is having a day. Defense is having a day.
Third down and six for Colgate. They need to get to the Holy Cross 45 for a first down. Brenneman, three-step drop, gets it out quickly. It's caught for a first down. Just inside the markers for the first down. A quick hitter that time to Oakley.
Yep, just got outside of Riley. Riley gets a tackle. But a good throw stuck in there by Brenneman.
There's Brenneman trying to get his team some points here. Brenneman under pressure. Buccheroni's chasing him. Brenneman slides down inside the 40. Oh, they're going to mark him down
Brenneman
at the 40.
Yep.
Where the ball was when his knee hit, when he slid.
I don't know how he got away from Buccheroni. Buccheroni just took a swipe at him. Somehow got away from him.
Buccheroni's got a great motor, nonstop. Just getting after the quarterback. Clock running, close to 11 minutes remaining in this game now. Holy Cross coming on the blitz. Brenneman underneath, incomplete, almost picked off by Riley. Almost had his second of the day. And that was a tough one, though, to put your receiver in that position, because you're just thinking ribs.
Well, they got a blitz coming from the outside, this Holy Cross. They almost get home. And Riley almost comes away with another pick. Gill is stretching out there. Gill almost caught it on the deflection.
.11 to play in this game. Third down and six for Colgate. Brenneman under pressure, hits it underneath. He's got a first down. It's a good read by Brenneman. Diaco, the tight end, was free, and he picks up the first down, and the drive will continue for the Raiders.
Yeah, they've been pretty good in converting the third downs here on this drive. But overall, Holy Cross has been really, really good and tough in getting off the field, especially in this part of the field. Colgate hasn't gotten much success inside the red zone.
Here's Brenneman to throw with time, and he's got a completion, and a flag comes in late on this one. Diaco is the receiver, but this one will probably come back.
It's a trip.
15-yard penalty.
It's a 15-yarder.
Yeah. You don't see the trip that often.
No.
There it is
right there.
See a little leg whip?
Yeah. And Buccheroni runs through it, but it is. That's an old school leg whip. Art Donovan would like that.
You don't see it. You don't see it that often.
But all of a sudden, now Colgate's backed up to the Holy Cross 39-yard line. Brenneman to throw. Holy Cross's offense now has become one-dimensional, trailing 31-3. It's what you'd expect. Nick Gill makes the grab. Colgate trying to get set up quickly, trying to run this hurry-up offense now with under 10 minutes to play in the game. Brenneman gets rid of it, and almost a great grab by Gill.
He almost caught it with his legs.
Wow, that was an incredible effort from Gill.
Brenneman had to throw on the run because the Crusaders just continue to pursue him just with three, four guys coming at the line of scrimmage. But their coverage is good downfield, so Brenneman has to go through his progressions, and the Crusaders are eventually just trying to get to him.
Mike Pucko's guys just bringing the heat. Gill's 6'3 and 205 pounds, a big receiver. Third down and 18 for Colgate.
I'm going to say this. We've known Mike Pucko a long time. Few coaches at any level get more out of his guys than Mike Pucko.
That's exactly
in charge,
right.
I mean, this is a head coach.
Holy cross.
A guy who could easily be a head coach at the college level. And, you know, certainly here in central Massachusetts. But he is a guy who gets a ton out of it.
Oh, yeah.
A ton out of his guys. He's got a ton out of his defensive line this year. There he is with Senior in the back there.
Yep.
And, you know, I'm biased because I like Mike Pucko. But, I mean, his record speaks for himself, you know, in college and in high school, and the way his guys that play for him do. He really is a heck of a coach. Look at that turf, by the way. It looked unbelievable last week, Kev. Harvard thought it was artificial turf at first when they got here.
It still looks good.
It still looks good, but you should have seen it last week. It was pristine after 6 weeks away.
Yeah, and I'm with you on the Mike Pucko thing. He should be a head coach in college, and wherever he lands at some point, if he is a head coach, he will be successful because he has been awesome. With Assumption, with Holy Cross broken up. Great defense by the Crusaders again. Terrell Prince gets a hand on it.
Eight.
But we've seen it at West Boylston High School, then at Holy Name High School. You know, and then, again, the college level at Assumption, Division II. Now at Holy Cross, Division I. He's successful wherever he goes.
Terrell
will be a phenomenal head coach.
Terrell Prince broke that pass up. He's got eight tackles to lead Holy Cross. And then he's made those plays on special teams as well.
That's a difference maker. 9.5 minutes to play. Fourth and 18 for Colgate.
They
get the sack. Well, we were talking about him. It's Corey Stefanik, one of the linebackers, safeties from this defense, who gets it. Stefanik gets in there and gets the sack. And this defense right now celebrating.
That's his fifth sack. He leads the team. And he gets to the quarterback. The Crusaders get home, and they get the ball back when we come back.
Elizabeth Warren talks about the 1%. She is the 1%. Now, if you really are so concerned about the little guy and the average guy and the middle-income person, where are you? Too bad that our own Congressman, Jim McGovern, doesn't have the fortitude to stand up and speak on behalf of the people in his community. They all go to Congress with no money in their pocket, and they all leave there as millionaires. How does that happen?
Welcome back. Now, while we're currently being broadcast on Charter TV3, we're also being broadcast online through Patriot League TV. And that's exciting because people that can't be here in the stadium can watch it from home. So you have friends and family being able to watch their kids, and including some alumni. And Jerry Carrington is up in Vermont, and she's hosting a 94-year-old Colgate alumni, and they're excited to be watching this game today, guys.
All right. Thank you, Brenna. The Charter TV3 reach being extended on this Saturday. Dagenhart will keep it himself. Slides down at the line of scrimmage.
Dagenhart with the keeper.
The clock runs. Holy Cross would love to have long ball control drive, keep it on the ground, and just keep that clock moving right now.
Yeah, they're gonna take their time when they have the football. There's Miles Alexander, senior.
Emmett Clifford is warming up on the sideline for Holy Cross. May even see Clifford come in for a couple series. There's Miles Alexander straight ahead. And Holy Cross blocking it. Or rather, Colgate stacking it up. A couple of Crusader offensive linemen coming in at the end, getting their licks in. Knocking some people down.
Hey, Dagenhart's had a great game. He's played well. 267 yards passing, 3 touchdowns. Again, taking care of the ball. And, you know, hasn't had to do a ton necessarily. But when he's been called on, he's made those plays. He's run the ball pretty well as well. A couple good runs, 24 yards on the ground. But this was a battle. It was a battle to get the quarterback spot. Dagenhart won it.
Dagenhart's under fire. Does a good job to secure the football. He's brought down for a loss of 4 on the play.
He won the battle. Emmett Clifford was the starter last year when things got underway, and obviously he still had some guys like Jeff Wade that could play last year, but you know he had to beat Clifford. He had to beat a really good freshman, Chris Boutash. He had a transfer come in from Division I FBS school, and you know they've got some guys with some skill and some resumes behind them in this quarterback group right now, and Dagenhart doing really well with the opportunities he's given.
Wilkinson with a high hanging punt, fair catch called for at the 28-yard line. Prince, no surprise, right down there. Timeout on the field, 7:15 to play in the game, 31-3, Holy Cross.
I'm District Attorney Joe Early Jr., and I'm proud to partner with Charter Communications with our pledge to help raise awareness that bullying should not be tolerated. From local school students, here's our message.
Step up so others won't get stepped on. Take a stand and lend a hand.
We need to foster safe environments for students in their schools and communities. Join the Anti-Bully Crusade. Take a stand to lend a hand. Don't be a bully.
Presented by the Law Offices of Joseph J. Coriglio.
Our founders would have never seen this coming.
Spygate?
No.
Deflategate?
No.
What then?
Benji! Benji knocks down any obstacle that he can get his paws on and tackles every high interest rate that gets in between us and our customers, which is why he made the Bay State Savings Bank team.
You're right. They would have never seen Benji coming, but I'm sure they're glad he came.
Bay State Savings Bank. We take banking personally.
Welcome back, everyone. Colgate huddles on the far side of the field. The Raiders trail it 31-3 here. Lehigh beat Georgetown this afternoon, so Lehigh's 3-0 in league play. Holy Cross would go to 2-0 in league play. And next week, it is Lehigh and Holy Cross. And even though it's still early in the year, I'm saying that would be for the league title. Winner of that will get the league title. That's huge.
We get to vote again on the MVP of today's game.
Colgate football. Matthews is stacked up after a 2-yard gain.
Nick Hague and I voted for Jacob Dobbs in a losing effort. I don't even know if our votes were counted. Hopefully they were. The democratic process and all. We tried to get him the Chuck Howley Award there. Yeah, the Dallas Cowboys lose the Super Bowl, but you get the MVP. But we'll see. We'll see how it goes. This is the Eddie Anderson Award for the family weekend MVP.
Brenneman from the shotgun. Brenneman will throw, and here comes the defense.
That's the Russian
right
author.
In. Dan Kuznetsov.
The Russian author strikes.
Number 92, Dan Kuznetsov.
Crime and Punishment. He's there. Did you ever have to read that?
I mean, not.
This guy, Kuznetsov, has been great. He has been great.
down.
Just a straight rip move, just a speed move. Rips through, I guess a little power involved too, certainly.
Oh, man. Pucko.
Yeah, 100%.
Pucko's guys are battling up front.
And this is the way they attack practice. It's no different. They're all over the field in practice, hooting and hollering at their coaches, challenging their coach, their head coach, Bob Chesney. Do you got the juice? We got the juice today and you don't?
I'm not even sure what that means. Hopefully that means energy.
Energy, yeah, it's energy.
Because
I had energy.
Or was it the fruit punch they give out in the media room?
No, it's the energy.
That's some good juice.
All energy down there on the
You've always been connected with the kids. You know all that. You know all that.
I
lingo.
Know the lingo. Yeah. I'm down with the lingo.
You're down.
I am nothing if not down with the lingo and hip to the times. 5:20 to play in this game. Brenneman to throw. Pocket collapsing around him. Fires for Diaco, the tight end. It looked like it hit the turf first, but they're going to rule that a catch.
Now, Diaco's a good player, man. He's an athlete. He makes plays with his feet, makes plays with his hands. Saw him make that acrobatic catch earlier. He's going to have to get off the field here quickly. As Colgate wants to get some pace going.
Kendrick Knight on the tackle for Holy Cross. Clock running. We are now at 5 minutes and counting. 31-3, Holy Cross. Matthews has a first down run. Riley throwing his shoulder in there. One of the defensive backs making the tackle along with Prince.
Nichols, not a win for Nichols there. Not yet, it's still going. Nichols playing well.
Brenneman trying to get some points on the board for this that has been just shut down today. That one will be close, but a little short of the first down. Holy Cross closing on the ball when it was in the air. And the clock stops. Let's see.
Illegal formation, offense, five backs. 5 yard penalty, replay first down.
5 yard penalty. There's head coach Bob Chesney, see Anthony Sarandolo in there. It might have been Mike Pucko as well. But this is a group, and you say it a group because the training staff, the strength and conditioning staff, they're all part of the team. They put in a lot of time, a lot of hours, every single week for one game. This is a group that will be smiling tonight. They'll enjoy this one just for a couple hours tonight, then it'll be back to work tomorrow. Forget about what happened. Riley breaks it up.
Now Riley's having a day. You could have Riley as your MVP.
You're right.
Today. Defense sometimes gets overlooked. He caused an interception. He has one of his own.
Yeah.
And he's the leading tackler. Not today, but he is their guy.
Oh, yeah.
Prince the leading tackler today so far. We went with Cozier. He doesn't have the touchdowns, but really that running attack set up the pass for Asante and Jewel and Degenhardt hitting those guys. It was really that offensive line and Dom Cozier setting the tone early in this one.
And that's what it was. That was early in the game. When this game was still in doubt, it was Cozier, the O-line, just coming up with big plays. Holy Cross sideline hooting and hollering after Riley came.
I think
you
wanted to give the award to the entire offensive line.
I did.
But this isn't like, John Madden in the old days where you can give out a turkey with six legs on or something.
Or the frenzy.
Or the frenzy.
We'd give it out.
We just give out to everybody. But
really, that O-line deserves a ton of credit because the running game, what Holy Cross was able to do, they ran for over 100 yards in the first half alone. Connor Degenhardt had time. When you complete deep throws like Degenhardt did, you don't do that unless your quarterback has time to throw and let those routes develop. And he had time to throw today.
I think they had over 100 yards in the first quarter, actually, right?
Yeah.
With the running of Cozier.
I mean, it's just a dominant effort by that O-line.
I think with 3.5 minutes left, we can say that this one's not in doubt. But this will definitely be a head turner in the league.
huge. Colgate was the preseason pick to win the league. Holy Cross was preseason picked second. Again, Holy Cross 31-3 up on Colgate. This is a huge win.
Wasn't Georgetown like 3 or 4?
Yeah, they were 3.
Lehigh wasn't really in the mix.
Not at all. Georgetown was 3rd.
Lehigh Holy Cross becomes huge next week, as you've been saying, but there's still other games ahead. You know, you win that game, you can't give up the ship, as they say at Navy, the rest of the way.
And look at that, Stefanik, a strip sack. And Colgate recovers, but Corey Stefanik continues to be all over the field like a roaming assassin.
That's his 6th sack of the year. And they had some guys on the edge that were rushing and had numbers like that, but I mean, he could be approaching territory where we don't see that often in terms of if he keeps this up, this pace. And he's like a safety rover.
Yeah.
And he's got 6 sacks.
And you know this defense wants to keep Colgate out of the end zone. And they got it. I think they got it there. It is. It is a touchdown for Colgate. They fire it to the end zone. And it's Aoki.
It's a great catch by Aoki. And he had Stefanik on him. So Stefanik goes from sacking the quarterback. And then he's back in coverage, and the coverage wasn't all that bad. It was just a good throw and catch.
Oki makes the grab with 2:08 remaining in the game to get Colgate in the end zone for the touchdown. Give the Holy Cross coaches something to yell at the guys about.
Yeah.
They'll get on them about that.
That's a good, and it's a good little strike for Colgate, too. Take something out of this quarter into next week.
Timeout at Fitton Field. You are watching exclusive coverage of Holy Cross football on Charter TV3.
I'm District Attorney Joe Early Jr., and I'm proud to partner with Charter Communications with our pledge to help raise awareness that bullying should not be tolerated. From local school students, here's our message.
Step up so others won't get stepped on. Take a stand and lend a hand.
We need to foster safe environments for students in their schools and communities. Join the Anti-Bully Crusade. Take a stand to lend a hand. Don't be a bully.
Presented by the Law Offices of Joseph J. Coriglia.
Our founders would have never seen this coming.
Spygate?
No.
Deflategate?
No.
What then?
Benji! Benji knocks down any obstacle that he can get his paws on and tackles every high interest rate that gets in between us and our customers. Which is why he made the Bay State Savings Bank team.
You're right. They would have never seen Benji coming, but I'm sure they're glad he came.
Bay State Savings Bank. We take banking personally.
Welcome back, everyone. We're being told that Dom Cozier is the Family Weekend MVP. He's a 2-time award winner. Not many 2-time award winners in Holy Cross history, but he's one of them.
Oh, here's a look at that touchdown, and it was a good one from Brenneman to Oki, and gets a little bit extra time in the pocket and just gets it inside of Stefanik. But how about Cozier? Yeah, you know, he really, again, he set the tone. We voted for him, and he won.
Yeah.
I feel good. I feel like
we voted and win. Dom Cozier, a 2-time winner, the Eddie Anderson Award. The last 2-time winner was Dom Randolph in 2008-09. Before him, Joe Segretti, 88-89. Jeff Wiley won it in 86 and 87. And Peter Muldoon was a 3-time winner, the old quarterback from Brockton.
Flag on the play on the onside kick. It was a pretty good one, but Holy Cross and Ianni recovered it. There may have been contacted before it went to 10 yards, but Holy Cross recovered the ball anyway. That's a pretty good list of names that Dom Cozier adds his name to. Is
huge.
The MVP.
A new quarterback, I think, too.
It's Emmett.
Yep, Emmett Clifford will come in and quarterback the team. Some new guys on the O-line as well.
Yeah, we got Nasuti out there, our guy from St. John's.
Neil Nasuti, what an athlete. He's a big guy, but an incredible athlete. Can dunk a football over the goalpost. Did it in high school. Miles Alexander met right at the line of scrimmage.
Ball's out. Is the ball out? The referee hasn't blown anything dead.
No. They're all looking to each other right now to say make the call, but someone's out. Someone's hurt on the field. It's Alexander.
I think that's Forrest, Kev, the running back.
Oh, okay. The freshman, Forrest, number 5. They like Forrest. They like him a lot. He's been dinged up. He's a big kid from New York, was a great track athlete, really fast.
These officials have to figure out what's going on in the field. So.
But this is a guy, Forrest, that they really have high hopes for him in terms of being able to come in and be a part of that running back crew that changes the face of games.
Bob Chesney's been talking about him all year, no question about it. He gets contacted there.
I think he's out. I think he got knocked out too, though.
Didn't look like a headshot.
He went down.
Yeah. He would be down. Obviously, Colgate can't advance, and they'd be down by contact.
Is that the runner's down prior to the ball coming out? Second down.
Yeah, it's tough to tell where the ball is there.
He got some good time. The ruling on the field was
he was down before the ball came out. So they'd have to review that.
It's right inside of the head. And that's what'll really get you. And they're smiling right now. You hope that it was just clearing the cobwebs right now. Nothing more than that. But yeah, he's a guy that they really like.
Yeah, Bob Chesney's talking to him. And, you know, I talked to one of the parents of one of the players on the team earlier today. And he says, you know, everybody we talk to and our son, they love their head coach. They love the atmosphere around here. Bob Chesney makes it fun. He makes it fun playing football here. And the student athletes, whether you're a regular player or whether you're a reserve or whether you're fighting for playing time, they really enjoy playing for this guy.
And the energy at practice, and again, this is a carryover to what we saw at Assumption.
It's fun for us when we go cover those practices, because not all practices are equal.
No.
But like Coach Chesney's practices are fun to cover, fun to be around.
Here's Miles Alexander. Alexander turns the corner and delivers a blow. Runs over the defensive back, and that gets his Holy Cross sideline jumping.
They're fired up.
Jeff Oliver's right down there to congratulate Alexander.
Here's where it is, a little extra. Put it down, and it gets another yard and a half.
That's an attitude run right there.
They love it down there on the near sideline. They're still kind of.
Let's see now. The clock was starting to run. The officials have stopped it. Here's Miles Alexander. On the sideline. I don't know what they're.
Well, I mean, one of the officials made a first down like signal, and he's short, obviously, on first down.
Third down.
And there, see, he has to clarify that it's third down.
But the clock should run.
Inbound, the clock will be started on my signal.
It's almost like they stopped the clock in order to set the chains because it was a first down, but it was never a first down.
Jonathan Abrams is the running back. Now they'll begin to run the clock. We'll see if Clifford waits and lets this play clock run down. There's 20 seconds on the play clock, and he is. He's going to just sit there. No reason to even get down in your stance until there's under 10 seconds left in the play clock, and now they do. They'll whittle this down. Third down and one. Abrams is the running back. He gets the call. Abrams has a first down and more. He's into the secondary. He's inside the red zone down to the 18-yard line. And the offensive lineman right down there to pick him up. They're loving this right now.
Yeah, I mean, that's his first touch of the season. Pretty good run.
Well, it seals it, too. They can take a knee now from here on out if they want to. They can take a knee.
Pretty good run there.
This should be the final play of the game.
Yeah, they won't need to snap it after this.
Depending on how quickly the officials spot the football. But this should be it. Abrams gets the call. Abrams battling. picks up another yard. Yeah, but that'll do it. Holy Cross will not have to snap it again. This is a huge win for the Crusaders.
Yeah,
this 31-10, utter dominance.
That's a big one. And yet, Degenhardt still has the mustache, so it's confirmed. But yeah, it's a big one. You know, again, in start to finish, setting the tone on the ground, defense making that play, especially on that second Colgate possession after the onside kick failed. I mean, a lot of good things to talk about here. And it'll be a much different Bob Chesney, I think, after this game than he was after the Harvard game, because obviously it's a win, but they did so many good things in this win. And they are still rolling into Patriot League play with 4 weeks left.
All right, we'll take a timeout, and Andy, I, and Brenna will wrap it all up right after this.
Our founders would have never seen this coming.
Spygate?
No.
Deflategate?
No.
What then?
Benji!
Benji knocks down any obstacle that he can get his paws on and tackles every high interest rate that gets in between us and our customers, which is why he made the Bay State Savings Bank team.
You're right. They would have never seen Benji coming, but I'm sure they're glad he came.
Bay State Savings Bank. We take banking personally.
I'm District Attorney Joe Early Jr., and I'm proud to partner with Charter Communications with our pledge to help raise awareness that bullying should not be tolerated. From local school students, here's our message.
Make the grade. Join the anti-bully crusade. Who wants a bully for a friend?
We need to foster safe environments for students in their schools and communities. Join the anti-bully crusade. Take a stand to lend a hand. Don't be a bully.
Presented by the law offices of Joseph J. Coriglio.
Brenna Wilson is standing by with the victorious head coach, Bob Chesney. Brenna?
Coach, team kind of firing on all gears today. What were you seeing out there?
I think there was opportunities that we talk about each week that when they present themselves, we got to make the most of them. I thought we did that today. We were able to run the football, which was huge for us, right? I think we were able to stop the run, and then we bent a little bit, but never really broke, you know, defensively to that really that final play. I was glad we had a chance to get a bunch of guys in here, get some experience for some other people. I thought we played as a team, played very well.
Your offensive line was dominant today. What were you seeing from them?
Just that, you know, they were able to move them a little bit. They were able to play physical. There's a lot of double teams at the point of attack, and they did a good job, you know, of sustaining those blocks and being able to get up to the second level. And the running backs ran hard.
And how long can you really enjoy this before you start preparing for the next game?
Yeah, a couple hours maybe. Not too many, though. Really, not too many. But I think it was a good job. There's a lot of stuff we'll have to continue to correct, but the effort was there, which was great.
Awesome. Congratulations. Thanks.
All right, thank you to Brenna. Thank you to Bob Chesney. Bob Chesney said the biggest improvement in our team from week one till now, he said really kind of outside of the Harvard game, was the offense, that the offense has improved more than any other aspect of the team. Well, they put on a show today, 31 points against Colgate. That's a big, big win.
Yeah, I'll tell you what. And week to week to week, they're getting better and better on that side of things, as you're saying, Kevin. Defensively making plays again this week against a good team that can move the football. And you know, yeah, maybe Colgate's not the best they've been in the last couple of years, and maybe not as healthy as they've been the last couple of years, but you've got to take care of business at home. Patriot League play, they more than did, and they got a lot of contributions from all over the roster today, as Bob Chesney just mentioned. And you know, offense, defense, special teams, they won the battles on all three.
That's Chris Smith, one of the best offensive linemen to ever wear the purple and white and to play for Holy Cross. Now he's the offensive line coach, and he was leading the victory song for the Crusaders as Holy Cross moves to 2-0 in Patriot League play with a dominating 31-10 win over Colgate. For our producer, director, Sean Grady, Brenna Wilson, Andy Lacombe, and our entire crew, I'm Kevin Shea. Thanks for watching, everyone. So long from Fitton Field. The Crusaders are victorious here today. And higher.